I didn't know.
Close.
We were close.
It was a spontaneous thing. Oh, okay. Really, we were super close. We just figured, hey, everyone.
Hi.
Welcome to Talking Simulator. I'm Cameron.
I'm Alex.
Again. Hey again. Nice to see you. So, I'm Graham.
We're here to return to the world of survival streaming. Well, I am anyway. Great. How
Welcome
do we do
back,
my job?
Alex.
Damn fine coffee.
There's a thing. Right, we do subs at the end.
Yes, we will do the
stream.
Sums at we okay. Welcome to Talking Sim. We will do sub shout outs and bit thank yous at the end of stream so as not to interrupt our train of consciousness, but they are being noted and appreciated. So hang on if you sub and want to hear a sub welcome message. Also, this is a 100% spoiled stream. So don't worry about talking about spoilers here. In order to talk about the game, we need to talk about the entire game. So
which also includes its sequels.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Any content warnings for the game we're playing tonight? Tonight we're playing Fallout 2.
Meat explosions?
Meat explosions, I suppose.
Yeah, certainly violence. Violence and exorbitant gore, depending on which perks you take.
Oh, right, yeah, because you can take the one that makes people explode when they die,
it's
right?
called Bloody Mess. Mm. Yeah. Yeah, like, there's sexual stuff, but it's, like, it's only described because the graphical fidelity at the time.
Hmm.
There's...
Did they say a swear?
Human trafficking, child slavery.
Just your usual.
Things like that. It's the apocalypse, so we can validate all the bad stuff. cannibalism? Yeah.
Probably.
I don't think
that's all I can think of.
I don't think there's an epilepsy warning for this game.
No. Maybe. Oh, drug use. Major
drug
use.
So much drug use. The jet'll make you jittery.
Yeah.
All right. So...
Yeah.
Business taken care of.
Yeah.
Welcome back, Alex.
Hi!
Special guest, Graham.
Hi.
Hello.
Fantastic.
We're talking about Fallout 2, because with Fallout 76 having been announced, we wanted to take a look at this venerable game series.
Yes.
And, Alex, you've played 4.
I've played 3 and 4.
3 and 4.
So I'm one of the new age heretics.
I've only played 2, and I'd never actually finished it. I only got about 20,000 hours into Fallout 2.
Yeah.
So I never was able to finish it. But Graham...
I played a lot of Fallout 2. I never owned it. It was one of those games, because I never had a PC early on. It was one of those games where I played a lot of it at other people's houses.
Also, just before we go any further, I like to start my stream with a Suntory Coffee Boss.
We are accepting sponsorships.
Yes, I don't actually have a sponsorship.
No, but
if
they wanted to, we'd take it.
I would absolutely take a Suntory Coffee Boss sponsorship.
Just fuck us up.
Think they could get Tommy Lee Jones to come over here? Are you okay?
I would shit. And not because of the coffee.
I love those commercials.
I would just be like, hey, Tommy, can you say the line? And he's like, then I woke up. And I'm like, yes! Can you just read No Country for Old Men to me, Tommy Lee Jones?
He's just like...
Doesn't Suntory also make whiskey? Yeah, all the drink manufacturers in Japan make every kind of drink.
Yeah.
Like,
really?
Yeah, Suntory, Asahi, Kirin, they all make alcoholic and non-alcoholic drinks.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And Hopushu, which is legally not quite beer. It's alcoholic.
In
it
Japan,
just doesn't get taxed that way.
You can drink in public, but you're not supposed to drink while walking.
Yeah, which I didn't...
It's not illegal,
I did not
but
know
it's
that.
A faux pas.
I didn't...
Bad manners.
Yeah. Anyway.
Okay, so, Fallout 2.
So this... Do we want to just
actually,
get
right
into
right, I was going to say, is Fallout 2 anything like Silent Hill 2?
In
the respect that it's the one that gets most of the attention, despite there being a prequel.
Yes, in the pre-Bethesda Fallouts, which is Fallout 2 and Fallout Tactics: Brotherhood of Steel.
Mm-hmm.
Fallout 2 is the very good one. Fallout 1 is still very good, to be clear, but Fallout 2 it was one of those sequels that's like. It took everything about Fallout 1 that was great and made it better, and there's more of it.
They found their feet.
It sounds an awful lot like the Demon Souls, Dark Souls series.
I suppose this can go, like, you know, several ways. One, your magnum opus is your very first game. It's the one where you work the best together.
No, you hold it.
No,
I can't. There we go.
This is great. This is good content.
Cool. I'll send it to you.
Hi.
And then everything after, you know, you have your what is it, the sophomore letdown. right? Mm-hmm. But then occasionally, you start firing on all cylinders, and you learn your lessons, and then you produce something that's better.
Yeah, it's weird. Like, sometimes the second one is the one where they get it. In fact, we were just before we went live, we were talking about Terminator 2,
mm-hmm.
which is probably the best Terminator movie.
Yeah, yep. I mean...
Weirdly.
Yeah, I think...
It's really good.
Especially if it hadn't been somewhat ruined by its own marketing.
It's perfect.
Yeah, like, it might actually just be a perfect action movie.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Like, Terminator, excellent film. Terminator 2, somehow better?
We'll get to that in a different thing.
Yeah, yeah.
But anyways, yes, the second in the series, mm-hmm. even, like, numerically, I guess is the one that gets all the attention.
Thank you.
Oh, you know what else?
What?
System Shock 2.
Yes, System Shock 2.
That's the one also, that got...
Yeah, another yeah. excellent one. Warcraft 2.
Mm-hmm.
TIE Fighter was probably a better game than X-Wing.
I almost said Super Mario Brothers 2, and then I was like, no.
Mm-hmm. Half-Life 2?
Yeah.
Better than Half-Life? Mass Effect 2, a very different game than Mass Effect. I would say Mass Effect 2 and Mass Effect are like the Alien and Aliens.
Yeah. But there, anyway...
Where the sequel is a very different, also excellent game.
Well, anyways, I feel like our point is probably well made.
Mm-hmm.
How did the marketing ruin Terminator 2?
Oh.
You're supposed to think that Arnie is the bad guy.
It's such... They go to such amazing pains to
In the movie.
That. It's so well put together.
Arnie was the bad Terminator in the first movie.
Mm-hmm.
And in the second movie, he's still being the bad guy, and the other Terminator shows up and disguises himself as a cop, and it looks like he's going to... rescue them, and then there's a flip in the middle of the movie, and you're like, oh shit.
It's really clever. But,
yes, it did ruin it, because the marketing told you that he was the good guy.
Yep.
Hmm.
Anyway.
So, the
Fallout series.
Mm-hmm.
What makes Fallout Fallout? It's set in a post-nuclear wasteland.
Mm-hmm.
In a sort of 1950s ephemera, super technology future, the kind of future predicted by like EC comics and shit like that.
Yeah, it's set in either the modern day or the close future.
Yeah,
22nd century.
Yeah, but as imagined by the 1950s.
So
it's like it's around now. I can't remember the exact dates. I'll have to look it up.
Retro futurists.
It's around now that the bombs are supposed to fall.
Right. And so that's informed by post-war Americana and pre-war science fiction.
Yeah.
Right? Lots of things that look like they're powered by vacuum tubes.
Right. Fallout 2 takes place in 2241, which is 80 years after Fallout 1 and 164 years after the war.
Hmm.
So yeah, it's pretty close to now is when the war is supposed to be happening. But this is all through the lens of, like you say, the post-war futurism of the 50s, of all like, you know, Johnny Atom and, you know, we just discovered nuclear technology, rockets to the future, sort of thing.
Powered by the invincible power of the atom.
Exactly.
Yeah, right? And it's got all the aesthetics, like the chrome, you know, sort of Bakelite.
Flying cars, robot butlers.
That sort of stuff. So
it's like the World's Fair, home of the future.
Hmm.
Home of tomorrow.
Was it Popular Science magazine, I think, had a lot of stuff like that?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's just like wild stuff. It's like, in the future, we will go underwater in massive underwater bus things for some fucking reason.
Oh, right. That's another good point, Chief Engineer Michael. What if we never had... What if microchips never happened?
Mm. Right.
Everything's made with vacuum tubes.
Well, and I imagine that a lot of the vacuum tube stuff is due to radiation.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Well, that microcircuitry is not reliable in this world, I think, is one of the subtexts. What happens when you combine the post-war Americana?
Throw that... Can you the with the plane? Can you throw that one up on the...
How do I do that?
Drag it to the desktop first. If you reduce the size of the exploit window up there.
Easy does
that. That works, yeah.
Hut.
So literally, this plane you find crashed in Fallout 4.
Really?
That's really great.
Like what? Like this kind of plane.
Hmm.
Yeah, this is sort of in a nutshell.
You just hit remove.
The kind of aesthetic we're talking about is Popular Science and Popular Mechanics magazines from like actually even earlier than that, like the 30s and 40s. Mm. They had some.
That was 1930. That was 1933. That issue. In fact, you find magazines in the game that are sort of this kind of like of this era sort of thing.
Right.
Man, how come Elon Musk hasn't made his rockets look like this?
Because he actually has very little imagination.
But chow! Okay. Well, shall we fire this up?
Yeah, let's do it.
Get stuck into it.
Play Fallout 2.
Ron Perlman, take us in. Oh, God.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, so I remember
turn
this
up
now.
The. You should be able to hear a little. Or no, I guess you wouldn't on the disc.
You know what that makes me think of? Warhammer 40k B keys.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Interplay, motherfuckers.
Heyo.
Yes.
That's some good resolution.
Rip to pieces, Black Isle. Give me a kiss to build a dream on. And my imagination
will thrive upon that kiss. Do you like stainless steel? I ask no more than this. A kiss to build a dream on. Right, of course, the other major conceit of this series. A series of vaults were built in preparation for the war, and many civilians survived that way, kind of.
Several civilians survived.
The shtick is that each of the vaults had a weird thing that they did. Look at these fellas.
That becomes less, that's less relevant in this.
Yeah,
in this,
I want to say that that was a Fallout 3 thing.
Was it?
Where they made many of the vaults into social experiments.
Hmm. It was pretty cool because, like, then we get stuff like, ah, Gary. Nice.
I like those, yeah.
Because. Is there an example of extreme idea?
Whoa! Okay, that's. Like, these ephemera films are very well researched. Like, if you've ever seen any, you know, kind of informational films from the 50s, they look just like this. Garden of Eden creation kit.
That's the MacGuffin.
Ah! I'm with you now, Ted. Results may vary. Authentic Fallout shelter sign. I think all the doors look like this, which is a cool design. It's just like this big gear that comes out and rolls to one side. Hello! Hello!
We greet you in peace.
Man, can you imagine generations living underground and they finally surface to that?
War never changes.
There it is.
The end of the world occurred pretty much as we had predicted. Too many humans, not enough space or resource to go around. The details are trivial and pointless. The reasons, as always, purely human ones. The Earth was nearly wiped clean of life. A great cleansing. An atomic spark struck by human hands quickly raged out of control. Spears of nuclear fire rained from the skies. Continents were swallowed in flames and fell beneath the boiling oceans. Humanity was almost extinguished, their spirits becoming part of the background radiation that blanketed the Earth. A quiet Some had been fortunate enough to reach safety, taking shelter in great underground vaults. When the great darkness passed, these vaults opened, and their inhabitants emerged to begin their lives again. One of the northern tribes claims they are descended from one such vault. They hold that their founder and ancestor, one known as the Vault Dweller, once saved the world from a great evil. According to their legend, this evil arose in the far south. It corrupted all it touched, twisting men inside, turning them into beasts.
Right.
Only through the bravery of this Vault Dweller was the evil destroyed.
That's the first game.
But in so doing, he lost many of his friends and suffered greatly, sacrificing much of himself to save the world. When at last he returned to the home he had fought so hard to protect, he was cast out, exiled. In confronting that which they feared, he had become something else in their eyes, and no longer their champion. Forsaken by his people, he strode into the wasteland. He traveled far to the north, until he came to the Great Canyons. There he founded a small village, Arroyo, where he lived out the rest of his years. And so, for a generation since its founding, Arroyo has lived in peace, its canyons sheltering it from the outside world. It is home. Your home. But the scars left by the war have not yet healed, and the earth has not forgotten.
And then there's this fucker.
There you go.
All right.
Have options? Are there...
So...
I think we're...
Oh, we can go all the way up.
Ooh.
1920 by 1080, motherfuckers!
Refresh rate, 0 hertz.
Sounds great.
Okay.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Wait for it. Hey!
Because it is 4x3.
Yeah.
Oh, well, why did they put those black...
So, I forgot. I'm curious your sort of read on this. Your character is what's known in... Because, I mean, I know that you've played Fallout 2 before, but your character is what's known in the Fallout universe as a tribal. Because you just... You're from a... tribe of wild people in the wilderness. You know, you're not trying to...
You don't have the agency of the Vault Dwellers. The imperative that they have.
Yeah, well, also, there's plenty of people who live in civilization,
such
as it exists.
Right.
And, you know, there's not no anti-tribal sentiment in the game.
Huh.
But it's sort of interesting that... it's the actual tribals in the game are actually quite racially diverse because they're just whoever was around in America at the time.
Right.
They're not actually, you know, there's no actually sort of direct correlation between First Nations.
Right. Well, I mean, like, what I wanted to comment when I going back on that was that I like that your character in this game being, you know, a tribal is not, does not have the agency, or the, not the agency, but the imperative to rebuild America.
That
comes
is,
as part of parcel with what the Vault Dwellers seem to want to do frequently.
Well, that's sort of your job.
You're just trying to live.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It has been at least 15 years since I've looked at this game.
Oh, wow.
So... I am going to need to get into it before I can remember a lot about what the conflicts look
I'm
like
sure
and how
it
presents
it.
Its themes.
You can get through.
Fallout was going to be GURPS, yes.
Sprug?
Really?
Oh, that click. Yeah.
Whoa, that is a handsome man.
Narg.
That is a handsome...
So you can pick a pre-rolled character,
mm-hmm.
yeah.
or you can create your own from scratch.
Hmm.
So your options are Narg... Oh, and you can modify one of theirs.
Right.
You go left to right there. Narg... Mingan.
Mingan.
And they each have their own little story.
Hmm.
Chitza. That's it. You got three options.
Narg is so hot.
So, excellent strength, heroic endurance, and great agility. Narg seems like a fairly straightforward fighter.
This looks so pen and paper RPG.
It really does.
I mean, I imagine it has a lot in common with that.
Well, I mean, so like I said, they wanted to make it based on GURPS, the generic universal role-playing system. Mm-hmm. Which
I don't actually have any antagonism for. I just think it's kind of amusing because we used to sort of play with it. There is somebody who was under the impression that I was talking shit about GURPS.
Oh.
And I was like...
No.
Anyway, go on.
But they, for whatever reason, they couldn't sort it out. I actually don't recall exactly what ended up happening. And so they created their own system, which is similarly modeled, but it's the special system. Strength,
right.
Perception, Endurance, Charisma, Intelligence, Agility, Luck.
Hmm.
And here you go.
Yeah. Okay, so Narg is the fighter. Mingan is the thief.
Yeah.
What
does 64% melee weapons mean? It means you have 64 of 100% good at doing a melee weapon.
You're pretty above average.
And Chitsa is the smart hero. Or the charismatic
with
one.
Sex appeal.
With Whoa. Sex appeal.
Girl pretty.
So should we create a character?
Go for it. Why not?
Let's have a look at how
look
they...
Look at this.
So here's how the system works. This will be very different if you're used to the modern Fallout games. So you've got your special stats, and they're set to 5 with an additional 5 to distribute, but you can also subtract from the ones that are there.
What's our dump stat?
It's
charisma, isn't it?
And then you've got your skills. Those are the starting skills. So small guns, 25, big guns, 10, energy weapons, 10. Energy weapons and big guns are way more rare. Unarmed, 50, right? But you can also tag 3 of those skills as ones you're particularly good at.
Right.
And then you have your optional traits, which I think you get to pick 2 of? Or maybe only 1 to start with. I'm not entirely sure.
Looks like... yeah, 2.
So the... Okay, the... What's this guy's name?
Vault Boy.
Vault Boy. Who is a recurring character who's... He's kind of the edutainment character throughout all of the like in-game literature. And boy, he has a lot of personas. So he depicts most of the special abilities and skills throughout the game.
Yeah, sorry it's so small initially.
Yeah, this would have been 640 by 480 originally.
Yeah.
Right.
And you can give yourself a name and a gender at the top. And your age, which I don't know is super relevant.
100. No.
Does it actually have thresholds?
No, the Pip-Boy is the wrist thing that the Vault Dwellers get.
It doesn't seem to affect things.
I don't believe the age actually affects anything.
I do like the flip-over.
Oh, yeah, the archaic dial.
Yeah, well, I mean, the aesthetic of this game is very, you know, retro...
Age is just
sort of feature punk.
So if I recall correctly, finesse is handy. Finesse is greater chance of critical hits. What is jinxed again? It's like a.
The good thing is that everyone around you has more critical failures in combat. The bad thing is that so do you.
Oh,
right.
That sounds
so. So it's
awful.
You and everyone around you just sucks.
That sounds weird.
So, if we're going to be a survival character, out in the world, do we want to try to make Max Rockatansky?
Do you have to pick binary? You do. This game came out in 1998. It's impressive. It even has women.
Yeah.
Unfortunately. Yeah.
Up top.
So Mad Max.
Oh, okay.
Max Rockatansky, right? The
okay. I didn't know what his last name was.
People can't. Yeah, you can drop your guns. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Huh.
You hit yourself. You yeah. The fact that the age is 16 to 35. Like, how would we describe, like, the Arthurian hero?
Ooh.
Isn't it Rockatansky? Isn't that his last name?
I believe it.
Uh-huh.
So, fast metabolism, let's just quickly go through the traits.
Okay, fast metabolism, your metabolic rate is twice as normal. This means that you're much less resistant to radiation and poison, but your body heals quickly.
Huh.
Cool.
Interesting.
Bruiser, a bit slower, but a little bigger. You may not hit as often, but you will feel it when you do. So this is the opposite of finesse.
That'll probably involve fewer action points.
Yeah, your total action points are lower, but your strength is increased. So these aren't, like, exclusive. Like, we can be a bruiser, a finesse bruiser.
So you know how, Alex, you know how in Fallout 3 and 4 there's the VATS system, yes, where you can just shoot people?
Yeah.
So all combat in this game is turn-based, using an action point system. It's basically entirely in VATS.
Huh.
Because it's a different thing. So yeah, AP is important. AP being your action points is important.
So what is our AP?
Currently action you have 7, and you'll increase that with agility, if I recall correctly. The little plus and minus.
Action points, yes.
Yeah.
Armor class sequence and many skills. Okay. So, is the classic hero just lucky?
He's pretty lucky. The classic hero is, like, a little bit strong, a little bit charismatic.
And you can increase these in the game. Particularly the skills. The skills increase quite a lot. You can increase your special stats in the game rarely.
Not that smart.
I mean, it depends. Like, the classic English
Dwayne hero. Johnson. Let's say Dwayne Johnson from The Rundown.
Well, like, how do you even, like, the classic American hero. Yeah, probably Wayne Johnson. Like, or High Plains Drifter.
Drifter.
You know, the Clint Eastwood. From The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. Like,
if that was the case, he would not be that charismatic.
Not charismatic at all. He's a quick shot. He's probably, like, high agility, high endurance.
High intellect, too. Like, he's a sneaky fucker.
Yeah. Yeah.
I saw that.
But, like, the
charisma comes along a lot in those.
One of my favorite interactions in this was one that a friend described to me playing Fallout 2, where with maxed out charisma, and I forget what it is, the
sex appeal?
Might be. But anyway, you could go to a shopkeeper and be like, I would like to trade my amazing shotgun for your junky shotgun and some bottle caps. I would like to trade my amazing shotgun for your junky shotgun and some battle caps. Until you take all their money, and then you rob them for their other shotgun.
So, wow, the fucking rubbins.
Yeah, so charisma lets you smooth talk your way.
Mm-hmm.
And, gifted. Yeah, gifted is pretty good to have.
You have more innate abilities than most, so you've not spent as much time honing your primary skill or skills. Your primary statistics are each plus one, but you lose minus 10% on all skills to start and receive 5 less skill points per level. That actually seems bad.
Like, it's actually amazing because you get if you check it on. So all your skills have gone down, but your all your stats have just gone up to 6.
Right. That does sound like archetypal hero. Right? They kind of are able to do everything.
Yeah.
They tend to have, like, one Achilles heel that sort of, you know, puts them in trouble at some point.
But I guess they're also perceptive, usually, because you need to be able to evaluate your villains.
Mm.
Right?
Good nature.
There's a lot of different builds in this game. Like, a lot.
Hmm.
And you will get to pick additional traits at some point, depending on whatever levels. I don't know that we'll get there today. But.
Like, do we want just high agility, or reasonable agility, reasonable intelligence, right? Action points. What does intelligence govern? The number of new skill points per level, dialogue options, and many skills.
Yeah. If this is one of my favorite stories about the game. If your intelligence is very low, then, because it's a branching dialogue,
oh, I heard about
one of your dialogue options will always be And there's now, if you're playing a character of normal intelligence, there's a character you can encounter named Tor, who's shepherding a herd of cows, and he'll come to you and be like, you help Tor save Moo Moo's being attacked, or something like that.
Right.
Like sort of caveman talk. If you have really low intelligence, you go talk to Tor, he's like, why, hello there, I'd love your assistance with these cows. Like, you and Tor
get each other.
You understand one another.
That's really good.
Torg? No, Tor. T-O-R.
He's the future Torg.
Mm.
Descendant of Tor.
Yeah.
So what makes a hero?
So
how do we build one?
It's really unclear. from the description there what luck actually does.
Right.
Luck just sort of sits in the background and goes, I control everything.
So, I've found that to be a common theme of video games. Mm-hmm. Luck is like this weird stat that you're never quite sure what it does, unless you like really look it up.
Hmm.
It kind of reminds me of one of the Mario RPGs had a stash stat. What the hell did that go for?
Oh, like mustache?
Yes. Seriously, it was like stash, and it was like a luck stat, where it's like, yep. It does something.
Maybe. So sort of like poise, I guess.
No, poise is pretty straightforward once you grasp it. It's just like your knockdown resistance.
Right. Luck is situational, but there are a lot of situations. That's, yeah, that is correct. Also shop prices, yeah. Stash was a luck stat, also improved store prices.
Well, there you go. Yeah,
so you got gifted, and then...
What do we want? Chem-resistant, chem-reliant, good-natured.
What do you want? We also got to pick our three tag skills, too.
Oh, right. I don't know if this works. I've done average strength, very good perception, very good endurance, because one of the things that continuously turns up in stories is, like, the hero gets defeated and dumpstered.
Yeah.
And then gets back up and resumes... Right.
Where's my whatever?
Yeah. Like, what's his name from Ninja Scroll?
Jubei! Holy shit! That movie's awesome!
Another role-playing story. I played a brief Exalted campaign with somebody who's like, I'm just making the Ninja Scrolls guy, and put all of his points into hit points, and had like 1,000 equivalent hit points.
That's pretty great.
At the beginning.
So
he wasn't good at anything, but he couldn't be hurt.
Bloody Mess has literally no mechanical effect on the game.
Mm.
It's just
an aesthetic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it is kind of... I'm not saying we should take it. I don't think we should. But it is kind of funny when you get a critical hit on someone's knee and their torso explodes. We found... This super apocryphally, we found that the left leg was where you wanted to aim. We this is when we're playing in high school. We believed that the left leg resulted in a higher chance.
Is this like the down and B thing?
Yeah, a higher chance of critical hit.
Yeah.
So we would always try to quote left leg someone.
All right.
Yeah, Bloody Mess actually gives us small strength bonus in Fallout 3. In this game, nothing.
I mean, like the American gunslinger, right? You would have fast shot, small guns.
Yeah. Big guns.
One hander.
So. Big guns and energy weapons are, like I said, much rarer to come by. Like, big guns are stuff, yeah, like rocket launchers, flamethrowers. It says right there.
Right.
Miniguns, rocket launchers, flamethrowers. Most guns in the game are small guns.
And then this is, like, your plasma weapons.
And Joe Chief weapons. Got it, the plasma rifle.
I love lockpicking, but that's just because that's how I play these games always.
In my experience playing the sequels to this game, I always found the like bigger, heavier weapons to not be that great. With some exceptions, though.
The energy weapons are, when you get to the point in the game where you can actually get them, are nuts in this.
Do we want to be sneaky?
The archetypal hero will, I feel like they have maybe a scene where they sneak, but speech, barter, gambling, outdoorsman, first aid.
Isn't high
unarmed.
Isn't high intelligence a little weird for the classic American hero, even for a classic hero?
How many times does the archetypal hero get in a punch up?
Yeah, fair.
Is melee weapons is not the same as unarmed.
Oh, right, yes.
Although you could take either or both.
Yeah, sneaking is kind of not great in this game, to be honest.
Also unarmed. In this game is probably not where we want to be, but...
Blondie has a Bowie knife.
Is Blondie?
From Good, the Bad, and the Ugly.
Yeah. Right, yes.
I mean, Blondie is also a rifleman.
Yeah, I finally watched that movie. It's really good.
Yeah, it's really good.
I mean,
it's one of those movies that I think 90% of the population has seen in its entirety in 5-minute segments throughout their life.
It's a good film.
Mm-hmm.
Unarmed is good if you build it right. Guns are sort of where it's at in Fallout 2, as far as I recall. It's been a while. It hasn't been 15 years, but it's been a while since I played it. So, yeah.
Yeah, we also don't need to get an optimal build mm-hmm. here.
I mean, repair is also kind of interesting, like Tico and the good... Tuco in The Good and the Bad and the Ugly.
Yeah, Tuco Blondie
and Angel Eyes.
Angel Eyes.
Like, Tuco builds his own guns.
Yeah, if we're going
that
for,
was
like...
a cool scene.
I actually kind of agree with Twilight Avalon. If we're going for the classic American hero, be lower intelligence and higher charisma.
But does that seem good? Fisticuffs, small guns, and lockpick?
Sure. Why not?
Let's do. What's our name?
Blondie? Brownie?
But intelligence is free XP. There are many, many builds. Our stat block seems flat. It is, actually. It's six and then a bunch of sevens.
Yeah.
Huh.
Oh, it's all sixes and sevens.
That's fine, to be honest. Like, I don't know. If we were going to take anything down, I would probably maybe take down...
Lars, Clint, Flaunt, Chad.
Like perception or endurance? Like, what does perception actually govern again?
Steve.
Sequence and ranged combat distance modifiers.
Oh, okay. So, how likely you are to hit at range?
At range, yeah.
Hank's not bad.
Like, endurance is your HP, but if you are ranged and you don't get hit...
Fair.
Is there a dandy geek in the chat? Hi.
Hello.
I like that guy. I get to go see him again soon.
Yeah, perception is good, you're right.
Brick deadlift? Think McRunfast?
Think McRunfast.
Kind of want to call him McQueen.
Yeah, sure.
Oh, you're right. Strength is a 5.
McQueen.
Sure, go for it.
Or McCready. That's fine. Okay. Let's give her.
I'm glad you're unarmed.
James Turner.
I'm glad your unarmed is so high, because the first little... Oh,
chosen one.
Is that a
there
bomb?
There are things you must know. The village is dying. The signs are everywhere. Withering crops. Dying Brahmin. Sick children.
This is just what they look like.
There is hope, however. A slim hope. That few know of. The old discs speak of an item called the Garden of Eden Creation Kit. It is said it can bring life to the wasteland.
Ooh.
This will be your quest if you prove yourself worthy. For that proof, you must first journey to the Temple of Trials. If you survive, come back to me. We will talk more.
Holy shit, we start in Sense Fortress?
Hands, chosen one. Prove yourself. Find the Gek. Be our salvation.
There's no snakes, but there are scorpions and ants.
Hmm.
That's spooky.
It's like ants, okay.
Wow! Look at that.
Why? That's it like this.
I don't know.
Well.
Oh, that makes more sense.
Nice.
So you can see the ants there. Can you go to the options for a sec?
Ants. Ants.
It's down. Oh, yeah.
Preferences.
Because I'm thinking maybe we should actually
change the resolution.
Change the resolution so that it looks worse but is bigger.
Yeah. I'm into that. Save game, and then you might need to save and load.
Oh yeah, subtitles also. I think it's the circle under your inv.
Skilledex or
which is that? Oh, it's the same thing. Okay. Mm-hmm. So yeah, wait. There's no way to change the graphical preferences in here.
I guess not.
Oh man, you can change.
Okay, well, we'll deal with all this when we come back in then. I guess, yeah, quit and then.
Yeah,
quit, change the difficulty in the middle of the game. I love that.
Hmm.
I think we've probably talked about how dumb this sort of like being
is there a way to...
married to one difficulty
oh,
level
wait.
Is.
Panel scaling. What's that mean?
Fill?
Yeah, try
fill.
Try fill. How certain screens are displayed. That's probably good, but... Oh, wait. Is there a way to actually change the... Go back into the options for a sec? Sorry.
Scaling?
Yeah, is there actually a scaling? Oh, times 2 scaling is on?
Is it?
Also ups the minimum res.
Enable X2 scaling, this will also up the min res to... With window mode requiring more space for its frame. Do you speak English?
It says it's...
Oh, it's... It needs to be in red to be on.
Oh, click.
So, yeah, click scaling.
Click the scaling. The little X beside scaling. There we go.
What? Wow, that's...
Oh, okay.
Okay, so now,
yeah, okay.
Now done. And then it's going to go and figure its life out. There we go.
Oh, okay. It looks better and worse.
Great. That, I think, is going to help everybody. Oh, good.
That's...
Good.
All right.
Yay!
This is what I remember.
Good.
Yeah. Okay.
So now go to the preferences,
and
just make the difficulty easy, because like, who cares,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
We're here to talk about it. Wimpy. Sure. Easy. Violence. Maximum blood.
Okay.
Done.
And then, oh, is there
subtitles?
Subtitles
on.
Okay, sweet.
Perfect.
Great. That's all good.
Yeah.
Okay. So, man, yeah, okay, so remember what I said about pen and paper?
You're in combat now.
RPGs? Right. This is like...
Okay, so...
The Vigigamified version.
You are now in combat.
Mm-hmm.
That is
four action points
to walk to the ant,
mm-hmm.
And then it takes three action points to do a strong punch.
So we have 7.
Those pips there is the number of action points total. So, yeah, go strong punch the ant, I guess. And then you click on strong punch.
I'ma fuck you. Biff.
By the way, you had a chance to miss that.
Huh.
Notice. Giant ant was hit for 5 points.
All right.
And then you end. So you can't end combat. Well, you can try.
End turn.
If you click end combat, it's like, no,
can't
you didn't. It's like, no, there's an ant right beside you.
Bruh.
So then, yeah, then you end. Then you end turn. Then the ants have a turn.
Hmm. No, they don't.
Oh. So right click on, there it is. Wait, right click on strong punch? So now...
What the hell does that?
Oh, that's behind... It. Okay, so the UI is behind Cameron, but a little bullseye appeared, and it made it cost more action points. But
right.
Now it's a strong aimed punch, so now you click on the ant.
Oh!
And now you can see where you want to aim.
Right.
Specifically, and you have different percentages to hit.
Oh, if I missed.
You only had 35% chance to hit.
Just fucking slam a jamma.
You're going for the high risk, high reward?
Yeah. I mean, there's not a lot of risk here. It did 2 hit points to us.
Yeah.
End turn. Oh no, wait, it already ended turn. We're back up to 7.
Yeah. I don't think the other... You whiffed it. Look, or you biffed it. You killed it.
Poor ant.
And then... Is the other ant even in combat with you right now? No, it wasn't. So now you can right-click to cycle through what your cursor can do, and you can search the dead ant.
Ooh.
Oh, it saw you.
No.
So I noticed that this series seems to have a trend of the first enemy you're fighting being some sort of giant insect.
Yep.
Because in like Fallout 3 and 4, the first enemy you fight is a giant insect.
It's a rad roach.
Rad roaches, yeah.
Ow!
Just punch it in the body.
Okay.
I'm a big fan, like,
no HP.
Of your Mike Hagar pants.
We parried the ant.
Nice.
Good hit.
And
trading furious blows.
I'm just imagining how this would look with, like, a terrible rubber ant on a stick being like poked at the actor and him just being like, oh no! And that's the close up where it like pushes the jelly onto your neck and you're like, oh, it got me.
So if you cycle through again until you see a hand, I guess you can't search ants?
I guess not. What about this over here?
That is a bench.
Hmm. Ah, yes, the good old animation in Fallout 2.
That's the animation for everything.
You hold right click?
Also...
Oh, no, sorry. Right click to the arrow. Then click and hold left click.
Ah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Got then, there.
But that's Ooh. Your... Oh, you have a spear.
Oh.
Go to your inventory, which is... Yeah. You can equip your spear.
Hey, that's a really gnarly looking spear.
Hell yeah.
It's probably made out of an old car.
This is one of those not auto-saving games, isn't it?
Correct.
Correct.
You should probably do that. Oh, I like that little, sort of wall hack you get as you approach, nearby walls.
Mm-hmm.
This is very, this reminds me a lot of the system that was used in, probably is the system that was used in Planescape Torment.
Or even, like,
Diablo. Oh, set auto run to on.
Running normal always?
Always.
There you go.
It just... It, unless you care about stealth, it's like... It just saves time.
It's a red thing. Oh no, that's a torch. Get him. Oh. Don't believe him, just ranch. The traditional RPG... Just like,
oh, because you're better at unarmed and melee weapons.
Oh no!
Aren't you?
We're fools!
So like, if you hit with this, it'll do more damage than your fists, I think. But I think you have a much better shot at hitting him if you actually unequip it.
Does raw dog it? Wow! So we're Kenshiro now.
Yeah.
There is an item to search in that room. Yeah, I don't think the ants actually have items on.
I've seen a couple of questions about how my holiday went. It was good.
Hmm.
I realized that I kept trying to think of stuff I could tell people that I did on it, and then I was like, I did a whole lot of nothing.
Sweet.
I tell a lie.
You can move. Oh.
Check this out.
Where is it?
I got ID.
Hey! Ooh.
Actually, I'm not going to flash that on stream.
Yeah,
but
smart.
We have a non-driver's license identification card that integrates your health card number.
Mm-hmm.
And it has an ugly picture of you. See, because...
Why does
because
your
I don't
have an ugly picture of me?
I don't know. Because I don't drink, I never really have a reason to... carry ID with me because I never go to places that card you.
Right.
So for years and years and years, the only ID I had was my passport, which I would occasionally haul out if circumstance called for it.
So you can search that barrel.
Ooh. Well, we've encountered our first barrel.
You shouldn't need to do that. You can just mouse over the actual barrel part. There you go.
Ah.
Got there. Ooh, there's a sack.
Inv.
What is it?
Healing powder.
Oh!
A very powerful healing magic, although it will bring the feeling of sleep to your head. It weighs 1 pound.
Downers.
I mean, you do have 25 HP out of what? 32?
Yeah, we're fine for now, right? Yeah,
I think so. I don't know how much healing powder heals you.
I actually have plans to renew my driver's license, which,
Maybe
I found
should...
my interim learner's permit in my file.
Giant wow. Ant triggers the trap and narrowly avoids the projectile shot from the wall.
Wow.
Huh.
Oh.
That must be these.
Yeah, I can't remember how to...
That's really scary.
Search for traps?
I think you just perceive them if your perception is high. Huh.
I believe that's correct.
Yeah. My interim driver's license is now legally able to drive itself. It's really old!
So you can go into that side room and fight a scorpion.
Why would we want to do that, Precious?
Experience.
Yeah, that's true.
For exposure, I don't know.
Oh my god! All RPGs, you work for exposure. You die from exposure, too.
Yeah. Punch it.
Falcon.
Right. Ooh, the brain. Wait, wow.
You can just punch it right in the brain?
Yep.
Sure, I mean...
6 points.
I was really hoping that you one-shotted it.
I mean, God, if I got punched in the brain, I'd probably be one-shotted.
Goes crack.
That'll do it, yeah.
Yeah. Straight to the brain.
There is another scorpion over there.
Yeah, I see him.
Yeah.
We're gonna let him come to us.
Smart. Ha! You used all your action points, you big dumb idiot.
Well, brain was working out well for us.
Yeah, you hit him in the brain for 6 points. Look at that.
I can't not visualize this game as the special effects from like a 90 or like a 50s movie,
mm-hmm.
or like a tokusatsu film.
You got 120 experience for that. So because these you can search. You just need to click with the hand, and you get a scorpion. I believe you can eat or sell them. And I don't know if there's anything else to search in this room.
Well, let's have a quick boo around.
No, not quite Harryhausen. That's like way too old. That's like stop motion. I was thinking like rubber monsters.
Yeah, like, B-movie kind of.
Yeah, rubber monsters are like really primitive animatronics, which is to say like not animatronics. Or just like, like a glove.
Hmm. Rubber monsters.
Was that director I ever mentioned? Which director? When? I don't remember. I can't remember either.
Can we look at the ground?
The early Doctor Who episodes? Yeah, there you go.
Well, there's the way into the next section.
There was an amazing one of the new season of Mystery Science Theater, actually.
Yeah?
It was a particularly good episode. I don't remember the name of it, but they had a movie that was clearly, I honestly loved it. I loved the way that they, what they did in this movie, which was, there's a series of like special effects. If you can search whatever you're pointing at, that'll be the default hand. You don't need to bring that hand up every time.
Okay.
A series of special effects set pieces, basically, that were essentially stage magic, but presented as if it was like amazing sci-fi stuff.
Hmm.
And it was really interesting, like these really cool looking practical effects. Like some guy was a robot and so he was like having his body replaced or something, and so they basically had like the extra thick force perspective table so they could like sink his body into the
table.
And then replace with a new body, and then he stands back up and it's all done in one shot. It was the Time Travelers. And it's the same as the sawing a lady in half thing, right?
That's cool.
But using it in a movie, and there's several things like that, using it in a movie as like amazing science fiction, alien science. I just thought it was really neat. It was honestly really endearing.
Sometimes practical or like almost non-effects are really effective. Cam, I was gonna tell you that like there's another sequence in Terminator 2 in the in the asylum where he's copying the security guard, and he's just walking along and he sort of turns and the camera pans over to like the wall that he's passing, and then when it pans back he's the cop again. And that's just like the actor walked in, but it's like really cool and probably save them tens of thousands of dollars.
I mean, the classic Terminator 2 practical effect is the one that used Linda Hamilton's twin.
That was insane! And they didn't put it in the main movie.
Yeah.
It's only in the special edition.
I
gotta tell you about this.
It's so good!
Okay.
Like, it's a very clever idea.
There's a sequence that they cut from the theatrical release of Terminator 2 where I think they ask Arnold's like, well, can you learn? And he's like, you need to enable my learning chip. In the theatrical release, he's like, yes, I can learn. But what they do is he instructs them to, like, cut open a hole in his head and pull out his chip and then, like, set a dip switch.
Yeah. So and, the shot that you see is Sarah Connor with, like, half her, like, up to here in Arnie's head. And how did they do that?
Well, they had a mirror frame and Linda Hamilton and Linda Hamilton's sister. And one had Arnold Schwarzenegger and one had a mannequin.
Yeah.
With the prosthetic in it.
So in the mirror, you see Linda Hamilton and Arnold Schwarzenegger, and she's just sort of doing this behind his head. And then in the foreground, you see a dummy head and Linda Hamilton's sister messing around in the thing.
And actually, like, pull shit. It's so cool.
Apparently, the cop thing you mentioned was also twins.
Hmm. No. I believe that for when he copies the guy, but the shot I'm talking about is, like, it's on him as the copy, and it pans away and comes back, and he's, like, he's changed to,
back to the
police officer.
Cool. Yeah. You picked a lock.
I did.
And you got 25 experience points for doing it.
Hey. Mm-hmm.
This room's got traps, for sure. Oh, there you go, you got hit for 4 points. So yeah, Yeah, you see the plate there?
Yeah, I see it.
You see a raised plate. Oh, you see the raised plates. Look at them all.
Hmm.
In your little inventory there?
Yeah.
Huh.
I don't know what you're supposed to do with that information.
I mean,
I think you. Oh, there's one right in front of you.
Yeah, they appear as you get close to them. There's another one.
If you.
Oh, I see them.
Interact with one.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. No, just click. You don't need to hold down.
Okay. Stone plate.
I don't know if that actually disarms them or whatnot.
What?
All right, well, you can walk around them because you have a high enough perception. Yeah, you can see them appearing.
Mm-hmm.
If you didn't have high enough perception, you wouldn't know they were there, and then you'd trip them.
Yeah, the thing in Terminator 2 used not a mirror. It used the frame of a mirror, and then nothing in
and
it.
And two rooms on.
And then, like an Arnie prosthesis.
Yeah, I wonder if they used a sheet of glass just to get the reflection.
A chest.
I should use healing powder, do you think?
Yeah, probably.
Fuck it.
You're at 18 of 34. So that's,
Yeah, okay, so...
Nice.
See, now I'm going to wax poetic on...
Lose one perception.
When my dad used to collect... what was this series? Cinefex magazine, which was a magazine series that came out frequently, and it would talk about
these rad scorpions.
Yeah, it would talk about how the effects were accomplished in all these movies. And before the advent of CG, it was a little more interesting. Like, I'm no longer one of these people who's like, all CG is crap, because that's ridiculous, you know. And if you should watch, what's the there's a video on Mad Max Fury Road showing that, like, the marriage of practical and CGI effects makes for the best of both worlds.
Yeah, I can't remember what it was called, but yeah, it's
so
really good.
But Cinefex magazine was really, really interesting because before they had that, they had to do all sorts of wild stuff to, like, make these shots. So, like, Predator, the first Predator movie, to get those thermal image scenes.
Mm-hmm.
They got an actual thermal imager built into a rig with the camera, like, at a right angle.
Neat.
And a mirror.
That's so cool.
The Predator costume was, like, bright red because they couldn't use green against the forest. This was actually back when they were still using blue screens. I think maybe the blue wouldn't have worked either.
It's like to get the camouflage effect?
Yeah. And, like, there was a movie, I think it was called, like, the 3-minute... It was either a movie or a short.
You didn't have enough action points, too.
Oh, right, in turn.
Which is faintly related to the theme of here. I think it was called, like, the 3-minute war,
mm-hmm.
where they wanted to do a series of nuclear explosions in the background, but they didn't want to use the archival footage from, like, atmospheric tests, because everybody knows what those look like.
Right.
And they're like, how do we do new ones? What they did was they got a tank of water, like distilled water, and they would drop a droplet of pigment in and then film it at a super high frame rate and then flip it upside down.
Mm-hmm.
So the like pigment like mushrooms upwards.
Oh, interesting.
It's not bad.
They tried to film with an actual thermal camera at first, and because the jungle is hot as fuck, they couldn't see. That's amazing.
Huh. Giant ant triggers the trap and narrowly avoids the projectile shot from the wall.
Giant ants wander around these traps all the time. You have just enough AP for a normal punch.
Yeah.
This actually holds up reasonably well. I was expecting this to be way more obtuse and difficult to use, but it's...
Well, I'm glad we have a bit of a guide on how to actually, like, activate some of the more advanced features, like interacting with objects.
It's not as difficult as I it seemed there.
Oh, okay.
You can't search ants, which is why that wasn't showing up. You don't actually have to bring up that thing every time.
See.
And you can, as Cam's doing, you can right-click to cycle between the movement cursor, the interaction cursor, and the combat cursor.
Mm-hmm.
These ants can't even hurt us.
Mm.
It's just because they keep missing you. And you keep killing them.
Yep. It'll be like, giant ant missed you. Giant ant missed you. Giant ant missed you. Giant ant hit you for 20 points.
What?
Yeah, so we can't search the giant ants.
Yeah.
They have no inventory, or they have nothing for us to steal.
You're still in
combat. Would you like to take our first break?
We should probably take our first break.
Let's
or get through the...
If I may. Let's get out of the temple.
Okay,
it's
we're almost done.
We're almost there. That's the end.
Yeah.
You know, and it's just like every time someone is like, "Oh, I want to play Fallout 2 again," they boot it up and they sit down and they get this, and then they're like, "Fuck, right."
Yeah.
So let's just get through it. And then,
yeah.
Then we can actually start.
Sounds good.
This is a really elaborate temple.
Yeah. I wonder who built it.
I don't know. You think that's not the end? Well, we'll find out in a second. Mm. You can search that barrel. Damn it.
The ant saw us.
We talked about the things the combat system did for the genre yet. There is a guy at the end? Yeah, but we can't see there yet. We can't see if there's a guy there or not yet. We haven't talked about that. Right, guns, how good? Wow, popular science combat.
SKS in a woods.
I do like that, this is kind of a tutorial on the fact that because you are going in this initiative pass before the ants, they still have action points left, so their defense is inflated.
Mm.
And that teaches you to reserve action points in order to buff your defense a little bit.
Neat.
They squeak.
Is that a thing? I had no idea.
It feels like it's a thing.
I don't know if that's a mechanic. I don't think action points have any bearing on your defense. Maybe they do, and I don't know.
Because when we attack the ants, when the ant moves up and then we move up and attack it, our to hit is 60% if we take a cult shot on their abdomen.
Oh, apparently it is a mechanic.
Huh. Mm-hmm.
Unspent ones add to your AC. Wow, that's...
I had no idea.
Huh.
Then if you, Yeah.
Hmm.
Shall we
save?
That.
What the hell is that?
Take a look at it.
That's a bomb.
Plastic explosives.
That's a bomb.
A chunk of cordex.
Military brand of plastic explosives. Highly stable, very destructive. Includes a timer.
Save.
Yeah.
Oh, you can't carry it? You can put a couple scorpion tails in there.
Yeah, why does the ant have that?
No, this wasn't a barrel.
Oh, okay.
Just take like, see if you can take like five of them.
Yeah.
No.
Nope. Done. There we go.
Save now, actually.
Mm-hmm. I'm assuming that this is, like, the skill testing part of
Stagger.
This.
Stagger.
I'm trying to remember, honestly.
That you can... it doesn't look like there's a mechanism for you to pick here.
Huh. Well, head to the door, though, because if there's a guy there...
Well, let's find out.
I guess not. Yeah, you're supposed to blow that door up.
This old worn door looks like it'd be destroyed with a well-placed explosive. So could a lot of things, dude.
So, yeah, there is a chest up to the right if we wanted to get it.
I do like the sort of, like, IDK.
So how do you think you use this?
I'm scared.
I'd assume you select it from your inventory.
Just punch it? Oh, this is gonna kill us. Just melee it.
We'll click on it now if you want to use it. In your hotbar.
Oh, right.
Oh, okay. 1 minute. Oh, shit. Is it still in your inventory?
Nope. No, it's right there on the ground.
Oh, fuck.
Ow!
Son of a...
You dive around the corner and hide from the thing and then...
Ant, get away! It's dangerous, Ant.
Yeah, it's going to be an actual minute, which is funny. And I don't actually know how time passes in combat. Oh yeah, many people died to that bomb by like not dropping it or setting the timer wrong or setting the timer and not leaving.
This part, I have some kind of like.
There's a chest up in the room.
Up in the right. Oh, there is too.
Wow, an actual treasure-ass chest.
Yep.
I mean, this is our second one. I wonder what that was.
Due to your inept handling, the explosive detonates prematurely.
Oh, that's bad.
Well, I mean it.
I'm glad we weren't there.
Yeah.
Huh.
Skill rolls.
That's really neat, honestly.
This, the text box, reminds me so much of just, like, classic text adventures.
Mm.
This?
I mean, this could be the game.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, it honestly could.
Do you know what this really
looks
like?
Could it have gone off immediately if we roll badly enough?
I think it can.
Oh, yes!
Yeah.
Oh, yes!
Wow, that's bad.
Uh-huh.
This really feels like somebody
More stuff. A chest.
The sort of quintessence of, like, a pen and paper RPG, like Dungeons, like AD&D. Mm-hmm. With their own sort of sci-fi bent to it, and incorporated like text adventure elements.
Yeah. I mean, that's exactly what it is.
That's probably why it works so well.
Because it was going to be GURPS.
Those are all
right?
good things. But yeah.
Earthen one, we moved over the text box because someone else asked us to see the UI that we were interacting with. So, I mean, it's tough.
I got you.
Actually, yeah, you could sit us just on top of it. That would actually work quite well.
Oh, that's...
Well, no, just... No, you can keep us on the left, but just sit us right...
Make
yeah, there we go.
Smaller.
There we go. That's good. Too small.
We are the mighty Fallout Dweller.
That's terrific, actually.
Rah! Hold up, Spork.
Lesser Scorpion.
Man, that implies the existence of a greater Scorpion.
That's the best kind of information, is like the... Just like... You find a tag, intermediate scorpion, you're like, whoa.
It's like how mini golf implies the presence of not only, the existence of not only golf, but mega golf.
Mini and mega golf. Macro golf.
Some people believe that we are currently inside a game of mega golf. The universe will end upon the first hole in one.
I love, like, you just, like, you get your taint absolutely caved in, and it's like, you were killed by shit guy. And you're like... Oh no! That means there's tougher enemies somewhere.
What? Okay.
Yo.
Yeah.
Yo.
I got lost in Victoria for 10 minutes.
Did you change your shirt?
No, I just took my hoodie off.
Okay.
What'd you have for dinner?
I have not had dinner yet. I'm waiting for James.
Mm. He had value.
That's your first mistake.
I have a relative time, and I'm getting.
Is that?
Ashley
what is
too.
That? What's the bottle?
Scorpion tails are not nearly as cool as the healing powder in the. What is the bottle, actually?
Brandy?
It's some sort of alcohol.
Antidote.
Antidote. Oh, in case you get scorpion poisoned.
What is... I have never seen a Fallout 2.
Yeah.
Which Fallout here do you think is the coolest concept? Vault Dweller, Chosen One, Lone Wanderer, the Courier, or the Soul Survivor? I only have context for two of those.
Yeah.
So I have trouble answering that question. I would say that it's subjective, but...
Yeah. So, like, they all have different things. Like, the Vault Dweller is you are in a vault. It's an active vault. Everyone's surviving there, but they're running out of water, and they can't purify water anymore. And you have to go and... No, you have to get
the chip.
The water chip.
Mm-hmm. Right, of course.
Because it broke.
Right.
Of course there's microcircuitry. The entire first game, you're looking for a chip. Oh, my God. Right, yeah. Brain. Thank you.
In this game, you're just trying to save your village. The courier, the lone wanderer from Fallout 3, you're trying to get your dad.
Right!
The courier, you're just in the wrong place at the wrong time. The courier has a backstory, but...
I suppose by necessity they are sort of vessels?
Oh yeah, big time.
I've heard that the courier is well-loved.
Mm. Yes.
People love the courier.
I'm fine on the courier. It's that New Vegas is a very good experience.
Mm. The courier itself doesn't have really any dialogue, just the courier, but the writing overall is good, so that way it kind of colors your opinion that yes, the courier is awesome.
Mm.
New Vegas is so good.
Mm. Chesties for my besties. You heard me.
There ain't shit in here.
Empty chest.
You should have the option to take a deuce in whatever chest you encounter.
Thank you, Driasynth. Save.
Oh, right. Oh, yes, save.
And we should probably start staggering.
We haven't made any decisions yet.
Quick save. Does quick save exist in this?
Nope.
Oh, no.
Yeah, it's so annoying.
That's butts.
No, you... What? Oh, is it locked?
Oh. Up. Sproying.
You fail to lock. Oh.
Yeah, it's not locked. You can just click on it.
Oh. Ooh.
There he is.
Hello. Yep.
Yeah, you just talk to him.
Did I do the trials?
Hello. So
I think there's a way to. So here's Dialogue Tree.
Greetings, McQueen. I have the honor of being your final challenge. To continue in your quest, you must defeat me in an armed combat.
Oh, well, that's
shall we begin?
Gonna...
So. Do you think you can get out of this without fighting him? Sure as shit can.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Is it in the dialogue trees, or is there a separate mechanism?
No, it's in the dialogue. Okay. You can't barter with someone who doesn't have anything to barter.
What would you like to know? Why do we have to fight?
Yeah.
The path of the Chosen One is not an easy trail to walk, McQueen. You will be faced with many challenges throughout your lifetime, and the most difficult of these will be dealing with your fellow man. There will come a time when diplomacy and tact will prove to be useless, and your hand must be raised instead. This challenge prepares you to face another human and look him in the eyes, and know that you may have to kill him. Is this a fight to the death? No, my friend. No, help, no, what?
Whoa, dude, like...
Christ, no, calm down.
Are you fucking nuts?
Can it be?
I'm glad we had this conversation.
Yeah.
Would you have tried to kill me?
You just, like, go for the throat punch. He's like, whoa, time out.
This is a ceremonial fight.
This is, like, one step above, like, symbolic.
Dude, I thought we were just gonna be, like, come out of here and, like, be like, yeah, we fought.
So, split?
Yeah, split.
Oh, my.
Yeah, you can kill him, it's true.
No, my friend, you need only defeat me. When the time comes, we will end the battle. Oh, okay. Yes, weapons tend to distance us from desensitize the effects of our actions against others. When you strike another human being with your bare fist, you both see and feel the pain you cause. Very personal and all too real, then. This is an important lesson for you, McQueen.
I want you to hit me as hard as you can.
Did you name your character Steve McQueen?
Yes.
So there
just
is...
McQueen.
I'm sure there's a way to talk out of this. Okay. But
we
maybe
might
you
not
don't...
have high enough charisma for it.
Charisma or intelligence, I can't remember. Yeah. But I guess not.
Well, you're good at fisticuffs, so you should probably just, like... clobber him.
Oh, you're gonna dumpster this guy.
Did you go mono fist build?
Yeah, you don't have the speech for it.
You just, like, suplex him into the brazier.
I'm ready.
Someone who's like, there's pork cooking.
Oh, wait, no, that's me.
Usatu!
Hit crack.
Do we just work the groin?
Work the groin.
Work the groin.
You can.
Work the groin!
Just
work
the groin! Work
you
the
just,
groin!
Like,
work the groin!
You
the groin.
Unload on his balls. You're just like, even if I die in this fight, you're not having grandchildren. Please work the groin.
He's just like, whoa!
It's like, okay, that's...
Maybe this is what he meant by not a fight to the death. It's a fight to the groin instead.
Duel! Warrior was...
Oh, he's... Wait, you said it wasn't to the death!
What's going on, dude?
I think he's just mad that you hit him in the groin.
He just keep... Yeah, just keep unloading on his dick.
Work the groin!
Alright, this might actually be the best game ever made now.
He's really whiffing on you badly.
Because, dude, he's probably throwing up right now.
You defeated me! You were the worthy! You chose one!
Hobbles down.
So, oh right, the chest that was empty, mm-hmm. That's where your stuff is.
Oh, okay. Right, hey. Right.
You have earned the achievement, Groin Destroyer.
Ball Puncher.
Groin Puncher, Destroyer of Balls.
It just adds an extra,
just take all.
Description.
Oh, right.
Like, you feel a sensation, not unlike a grape bursting. Perhaps a ripened
Junk
claw.
Buster McQueen.
Why do they call you Cock Knocker? Well, you see, it's a very BAM!
He'd do the splits and cock punch them. Hey!
Wasn't that in, Bloodsport? When he's fighting the Russian guy?
Maybe. Doing the splits and cock punch?
I don't know why that's so hilariously off-center, but I assume it's something to do with the scale.
Yeah.
Well, I guess it's...
Yeah.
Hey, it's a vault suit. Yeah, Johnny Cage.
This business card just says Cock Knocker.
So, shall we save and take a break?
Yeah, all right.
All right, let's do it.
Okay, we'll be back in 5 minutes.
Yeah.
See you guys shortly.
I'm gonna turn this down there.
Beep, beep, beep. Beep, 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 beep.
Anyway.
Can I get those headphones?
It's
okay.
I just totally ganked yours.
No, don't worry about it.
All right, so we just wailed on this guy's dick until he ran away.
Yeah.
I mean, which, if I just hammer on someone's groin 3 times and they're like, all right, I'm out, I would be like, actually, I think at this point I should be the one running away.
Yeah.
Usually one is enough.
You can't see behind us. There we go. Level.
Ooh. I have a level to...
You get to level up now.
Ooh.
Nope.
First.
I'm going to run all the way over here. Because I clicked on the thing. Skill dex. Nope. Cha.
You know
skill
what?
Points.
So you have 14 skill points to distribute. And that's it.
I'm idolized in Arroyo.
In Arroyo.
You kicked a cat? Fuck you!
That's just the description of karma.
Oh.
So...
Oh, if you kick a cat, you get hit by lightning. Yeah, that adds up.
Okay.
Should they cheat the stats with reducing stats? Is it a thing you can do?
I don't think we need to game this very hard.
So, how do we want to spend our points? How do we raise our stats? Because there is a mechanism for it, isn't there?
Yeah, but not yet.
It's late game, you get a thing that raises one of your stats,
right? I think
right?
So, yeah. Basically, it's skill points now.
Yeah,
it's like
okay.
A syringe you jam into your forehead. It's like, it hurts so much! I'm smarter now.
Yeah, we're already on the easiest difficulty. I don't think we need to cheese it.
Yep.
So... Percentile systems always challenge me. I like how the rabbit has 3 years.
Yeah. Did they discuss the forced-in tutorial? Not yet. But yeah, that's that whole sort of level was a tutorial. That was it was not only a mechanical tutorial for you, the player, but a thematic tutorial for your character.
Yeah, exactly. These are the challenges that you can expect to encounter. There may be monsters. There may be traps.
Yeah.
There may be a dude who blocks your path.
Yeah. So, I guess we could... Do we lean to our strengths? I guess. That should probably be our...
I mean...
Percentile systems reward focus.
Yeah, your unarmed is already 64, so you could definitely put more into guns.
Hmm.
Go!
There. That feels like an overall improvement.
Mm-hmm. Right, tag skills get double what you put in.
Right.
Because they're your
bread and butter.
They're your proficiencies, yeah.
All right, so let's just continue to lean into our strengths.
Go for it. So now you can do whatever. You can talk to people. You can, I guess you could talk to the elder.
Hello, I hear you are the chosen one. Now, perhaps our village can be saved. Can you tell me where I can find more healing powder?
Got any more of that healing powder?
Healing powder. It's like, your wounds didn't get any better. You just don't care as much.
Where is the elder? Is she in here?
She's in the tent you were standing outside.
Look at that head.
Yeah, okay. The big
that's
giant
what,
head.
That's what the gas does, Alex.
What?
Congratulations.
Makes your head big.
Laughing gas.
Maybe. You laughing gas makes you not care.
Are you ready for your quest? Oh, I heard about that in a comedy routine by Robert Klein, I think.
It is from the Holy Vault 13. Vic, a trader in Klamath, brought it to us. He may know where the vault is. You may also need some of what they call money.
Money?
$152.
Is there anything more that you can
what
tell me?
What do you need? It is a holy artifact. The Garden of Eden creation kit. The discs promise it will make our lands green and our village prosperous. It will save us. More, I do not know. What do you need? Klamath is to the east. What do you need?
Yeah, I do kind of like that the idea of money is kind of quaint to this village.
The vault dweller knew. His tales have the sound of a perilous journey. What do you need?
All right.
Thanks,
well,
creepy grandma.
What's in the? Can you search that chest?
It's like grandma detects you.
A knife.
A kniffy.
We just stole from grandma.
Thanks, Grandma.
That was my kitchen knife. I can't prepare food without it.
That was my shanking knife.
I shall starve.
Is there anything we need to do here? Do we need to check in on the Brahmin? Should we talk with all the...
You don't need to do anything, really.
Hmm. Oh, Brahmin. I like that this looks like somebody in the early stages of an RTS setting up a village.
Hmm. Oh, everyone seems to have the same thing to say.
There might be a couple people that don't, but they could look in their tents, but you can also do the look at those green sections to, and that should tell you where that goes, because that's a map load.
Hmm.
So I think you can, or not?
Apparently not.
There are some significant characters around. But
other fixtures of this game, where did the super mutants come from?
You see a plant of dark soul. The super mutants were an experiment for FEV. I can't remember what FEV stands for.
Oh, is the forced evolutionary virus?
Yes, thank you. And they were like, what if we take a person and...
Greetings, chosen. Why does the earth before me warm to the touch of your passing?
I don't know.
Pump them full of stuff, and then they turn into super mutants.
Oh, that doesn't sound like a very good experiment.
The earth sings with the news of a champion upon the land. Perhaps
so now they're just like,
go, you would
they're
ogres.
Kindness. And they hang out.
Basically.
They fight you and yell.
It's a big focus of the first game. Yeah.
Many seasons have touched my bones.
Also, in Fallout 4, some of them melee you with atomic bombs.
Yeah.
Which is kind of
that
funny.
You be my champion.
Rubbish!
May the gods bless your efforts, chosen. May your aura grace my presence when the earth breathes clean again.
I love that you can be super shitty to this guy.
Yeah.
Eat my whole ass.
Search his barrel.
Ooh.
Just gonna stick my hands in your barrel. You find feculence. This is where he shit.
Plants of Dark Soul. Do we fast roll past them?
You could just not go near them.
He asked us to fight them, though.
Oh, okay. Well, fair enough.
Strong kick.
You can cycle through.
Sorry, are you fighting a plant?
You should be able to. Oh, because you're.
Oh, far away.
You're too far. You can kick from one square away?
Apparently. Nice. Target out of range.
Don't! Oh.
You can still do a punch at least. You only takes 3 AP for the punch. Why can't you punch?
I don't know.
What's in your inventory?
Do plants have nards?
Okay.
The base?
Sense tendrils.
Usul is the strength at the base of the pillar. I guess we just...
Oh! That's that button.
What?
That button is to change what your... The red one.
This one?
That's... Yeah, that's to
oh,
change.
Okay.
Your,
oh.
There
ah!
you go.
So we currently have 8.
Yeah, so you can do 2 aimed punches.
Give him a strong style.
I mean, so the central stock is 58, which is just an unaimed punch.
Yeah.
So you don't even need to aim if you're not gonna... Like, if you're gonna hit the central stock, you don't even need to aim and it takes less AP.
Right, and that will leave us with some AP up.
Yeah.
We're just engaged in fisticuffs with a plant.
So, you know the scene in Enter the Dragon, where
this plant is tough.
He's fighting the guy, and at the end, he like does that slow motion jump and like twists his ankle and like looks really angry and then really upset and sort of lost.
Yeah.
They lampoon that in Kentucky Fried Movie. He does. Broadly speaking, the same thing, and then the guy just gets right back up as if nothing happened, and then he sort of mouths the words, what the fuck, and then the next time he defeats him, it's the same slow motion, like, up angle shot, but he picks up an engine transmission and just, like, throws it off camera, and you hear this crunch noise.
Wow.
It's good.
It's like in Blade when he cuts Frost in half at the end, and he knits back together, and Blade, like, he's doing his, like, pose with his sword.
Yep.
As he, like, you know, goes into the classic, like, Kurosawa post
yeah.
sword slash pose, and he just looks over his shoulder at him, and the shot is silence, and Wesley Snipes just goes, right? Like, just mouths, what the fuck?
You should probably watch that movie again.
I don't know if I want to watch that movie again, because my memory of it is that it is one of the greatest action movies ever made.
It's probably quite bad.
Like, it's probably garbage.
Yeah.
But I enjoyed it a lot.
This plant is basically the Dark Souls of plants.
Can we? Never mind.
No, absolutely not.
The text box literally described it as a plant with a dark soul.
Oh!
Yeah, it's the plant of Dark Soul.
Okay. Is it the first or second Blade movie where he suplexes somebody to death?
Yes.
Like, vertical suplex.
Oh, this is like the fight in that gets described in the Two Towers.
I mean, Triple H is in the third Blade. He is.
I believe you.
For 3 days I fought the Balrog, till I smote his ruin upon the mountainside.
You went
all right.
up a mountain?
Gandalf, roll attack. Miss. Balrog attacks. Wing, miss. Wing, miss. Whip, miss.
Bite.
Gandalf,
miss.
It's your turn. Roll attack.
Yep.
Miss.
Ryan Reynolds was also in that movie. And Jessica Biel?
Yeah, Jessica Biel. She listened to music during the fight scene. She
right.
had an iPod.
Yeah, I remember reading an interview about Ryan Reynolds getting the shape of that movie. And they're like, how did you do it? And he's like, I ate 3 roast chicken every day.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
Bones and all.
Is that like Benedict Cumberbatch talking about getting in shape to play Sherlock Holmes? Or the diet he was on to play Sherlock Holmes, his fitness regimen? He's like, all they let me do when I'm not filming this thing
Kale.
Is eat spinach and swim.
Wow.
Like, all right, I'm off scene. All right, what do you want to do, eat spinach or swim?
I want to die.
Nope.
Not on my watch. Just it's like foie gras, only like a stick, and it's Benedict Cumberbatch, and it's spinach.
Turn the spirit of the dweller to the world and bring a smile to the soul of an old man in passing. For this, I give you powders of healing. Remember, they fog the mind as they cleanse the body.
So cocaine.
And also, will I mix the brock flower with the xander root together whenever you bring both to me? May your pathways be true.
That's to make more
your
healing.
Heart follow suit.
So does this game have vacuum tubes and integrated chips?
I believe so.
I don't care. That's cool.
So you can put the knife in one of your slots and still just choose not to use it.
Oh, okay.
That's a big knife. So
now, do we have anyone we can trade with here? We can just get rid of our spears.
Presumably.
This is a brief...
Maybe you can barter with that guy, actually.
Sort of useless this... observation.
No, the guy you're just talking to.
Oh, okay.
Like... all the dialogue menus have the barter option. Hmm. If you can, it'll... So he's got nothing, so no.
Okay.
Like, a really long time ago, I saw somebody start a game of Fallout 1, and the thing that really struck me was the pistol. The first pistol you get is a pistol that Jeff Darrow drew in Hard Boiled.
Wow.
Like, it looks the same.
That's back to the...
I'm gonna...
That's back to the temple, right?
Yeah. I'm sure there's... one. Check one of the other tents. I'm sure there's a merchant. And someone pointed out Amethyst. So by putting it in that slot, you can now use knife or kick. If you put it in your other slot, you can use knife or punch.
Oh, okay. Well, let's do that. Punch seems...
So, try that.
This is the Elder.
Is it?
Isn't it? Oh no, she's here.
There's gotta be someone around here.
Hmm.
No.
No?
Down there?
Maybe.
You went in there. See, well, it needs to be repaired. You repair the well. You got 100 XP for that. Good job.
The well is working fine. Hooray!
Yeah, try that tent and see.
Nope, does not appear to. Oh, wait. Search.
Sick!
We're just gonna steal somebody's cash.
Yep. Yours now. You talk to her. Nope.
Oh, we just stole our auntie's cash.
Eh. Oh yeah, you can search the shelves there too, I think.
Oh.
Yep, that's a searchable object. Nothing. Alright, well, I guess leave then?
Yeah, I guess so.
Try bartering with her. Da 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 da. Oh.
No, no.
So, probably save once you load here.
Hmm.
Ah, one of these people might be. I like that this doesn't go full widescreen because this screen was never meant to be seen.
Hmm.
is never meant to be seen. Like, there just isn't. It's only meant to be one width. You can search the shelves there.
Oh, right, right, right. This is a part of these games that always makes me feel a bit awkward.
What, searching people's shit?
Yeah, just running.
Oh,
rummaging
I just
through
steal
people's
stuff.
No grand send-off, huh?
Nope. They don't want to make a big deal about it.
I mean, you're the third one this week, so really.
That guy you can talk to.
Yeah, this is the guy whose groin we wailed on.
Hey, Graham, tell me how you feel about this. Okay, 10mm pistol from Fallout, and I think this game as well. Boop!
Oh, wow.
Huh, yep. Yeah.
Frank Miller, Jeff Darrow, hard-boiled. That's the 10mm. Also, the 223 pistol is just Deckard's blaster.
Yep.
Hmm.
So how about them apples? Which game references?
Does he have anything to barter?
Wait, what
did he say about your aunt Morlis has been hoarding a piece?
A flint. Oh. If we give him a piece of flint, he can upgrade our spear. Maybe we can barter with our aunt.
Come on.
Oh, well, I thought we tried.
Oh my God.
I guess try again?
Yeah, maybe now that we know what we're going for. Monok said they might have some flint. 3 doses of healing powder. I have 3 right here.
Wait, see if you can steal it back. Save.
Pickpocket?
Yeah, so this comes up a lot. So stand directly behind her. Now rank your skill dex. You actually just click on her with that menu. You gotta cancel the skill dex. Maybe it is steel?
We're just... Alright, really? Yes, Aunt Morris.
Did you get it, though?
No.
Didn't get it, okay.
How's our karma?
Well, you're not Satan.
You're
yet.
Still
idolized.
You're fine.
Yeah, we're fine.
You're fine. Alright, take off.
He tried to steal from me, and everyone's like, yeah. Yeah, probably, yeah.
Have you met your nephew?
Just to point this out, the 223 pistol in this game isn't just, like, inspired by or a reference to.
No,
it's literally... Well, no, it's a reference, but because it's literally the same.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Which is kind of
entertaining. What's your fancy-ass new spear look like?
Also, there's a deagle.
Sharpened spear.
Ooh.
4-13. All right. Let's cross ourselves a bridge.
Yo.
Cross the bridge.
And now, the red means map.
Hmm.
Wait, what? Oh.
Where do you want to go?
I guess
you can go anywhere.
Hmm.
I love the...
The label maker?
Yeah, the label maker. So, for those of you who don't know this...
You can also go anywhere.
This style of label used to be created with a piece of adhesive plastic tape that there was a gun with a disc on it that had all the letters on it, and you would pull the trigger and it would imprint each letter in sequence, and you would just like it was.
I want to talk a bit about the map before you go in.
Yeah.
So. You can go anywhere you want. You can just wander off. And if you find towns, you can go to town. You can go anywhere in the game right now, if you know where it is.
Hmm.
Also, the areas that aren't town,
mm-hmm.
you can just click on them
mm-hmm.
and go there.
Hmm.
And it will load an area.
Right.
That is just like,
here's
an area.
This is what this looks like.
You found some dudes. Good job. But also, in that time where you were walking, you could have hit a random encounter.
Mm-hmm.
And so, and a lot of the random encounters are just enemies.
Yeah.
Sometimes they're interactive and not enemies, and sometimes they are, very rarely, there's a lot of joke encounters or reference encounters.
Right.
Someone already said that in the first game, there was, you found, like, a crashed telephone box.
Right.
It's like, definitely Doctor Who, but not really. Mm-hmm. But you can find a lot of weird stuff in this game.
Hmm.
Anyway, but now you just click on the arrow, and you'll go to Klamath. No, actually, yeah. In the middle of the...
In the middle of the thing?
Yeah, in the middle of the arrow.
This one?
Yeah.
There we go. Sorry.
Now you're in
Klamath.
Hello. Oh, hey, it's night.
It's a shitty.
You entered a small town called Klamath. It is night. You can also wait till morning if you would rather see during daylight.
Meet Tor.
Hey, Tor!
What up, Tor?
Nice to meet you, Tor. Anything interesting happen lately?
Bugmen take moo-moos at night. Tor scared. Hep Tor.
Hep Tor.
Sure, Tor.
You Hep Tor, moo-moo's field. Now, yes?
I...
Help him. Why not?
Must help Tor.
Must
keep Tor safe.
Hep Tor.
What are those big red things?
Brahmin. The Brahmin are the two-headed cows.
Of legend.
You got a 50-50 shot to hit the brain there.
Wow.
Good job, you killed it. Is that it? Oh, who are those people? Oh, is that it?
Yeah, who are these guys?
These thirsty fellas.
Hello.
What up?
What the heck are you doing here? You here to help us or not? We might have a job for you if you're interested.
Sure.
One thing that we could use some help with. What's that? Here's the deal. We need some help in liberating some Brahmin from that idiot Tor. You can just try to talk him out of the Brahmin or knock him out. Just don't hurt him too bad or it'll stir up a ruckus.
You sons of bitches.
I don't think we want to help you steal Tor's cattle. Word to the wise, you just better not say nothing to nobody, because if you do, that would make us very angry. You don't want to see us angry. Don't want to see you angry. I don't want to see your ugly mugs at all.
Okay, now pop them in the back of the head.
You can also just choose to attack them.
Pop them. Yeah! Fuck them up!
Work the groin!
You killed that man by punching him in the
He was critically hit in the groin, and without protection, he falls over groaning in agony.
Nice. I've been waiting for this. Oh, you're gonna be talking out the other side of... Oh, wait, he got up?
Oh, yeah, he wasn't killed. Oh. He was just critically hit with a punch to the groin.
Work it. I've been working all the time.
A fucking clown. How dare you?
How? You sound like somebody who wants to get punched in the dick.
One of those times they missed, and one they were hit for no damage. Critically hit for 9 points, the pain is too much, and he collapses like a rag.
Work it! Work it!
He's on the ground. And
you're just like hammering on his dick. It's like, stop! Stop! I like how Tor is just standing over here, and you're just like on your hands and knees.
Just, what?
Just feeding. Like, your knuckles are starting to split as you hit, like, gravel.
Shot after shot to this poor man's groin.
Stop, he's already dead.
So I think you can...
I mean, you should probably
I think you can end the combat now. I could be wrong.
We punched him in the groin until he fell unconscious.
Yeah, they're not dead, but they're... Ooh! That's gonna help your punches so fucking much.
Boop! They just...
They just got back up?
Alright, well, I guess you gotta kill him then. You can open your inventory and equip the...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's gonna be good.
Because this still counts as unarmed.
Ha!
You can, and you have just enough AP to do an aim.
Oh my god, no. No. Oh, no. Oh!
Take it hard. You ain't seen taking it hard yet, son.
You're about to take it. Oh, you lucky. Wow, oh, God! The spikes!
I hope they didn't heal. I doubt they did. I guess that was just a down from, like, down from critical.
Hmm.
Wow, these guys suck. I mean, you're also not hitting. There was at least one instance there where after a series of misses, one of them hit you for no damage.
Hmm. Yeah, I hit for no damage again.
Yeah. Did you just knock that guy backwards? Or was that a critical fail on his part?
I don't know. Hitting the groin for 7 points of damage. Missed and
critically missed and lost his next turn? What compels them to risk their groins like this?
Okay, go with me on this journey. A God Hand reboot where you can only punch them in the dick.
This is non-optimal. Or is it?
I wonder if Tor would help you.
I guess optimal is like just actually punching them with whatever, just doing unaimed punches and saving your AP.
Yeah.
But it seems like you don't need the AP because... There we go.
He's bleeding to death.
Yeah, no, he's dead. You killed him with repeated shots to the groin.
You punched his ball so hard he died. He fucking died.
Just the femoral artery. The penile artery. The penular region. Oh, God. Dutton was hit in the groin for 6 points and was killed.
God, this is reminding me of...
Now you can search them again.
Does anybody know about our RoboCop remake?
You can end combat.
Did I tell you about this?
Which?
Okay, so when the, like, 2000s remake of RoboCop was announced, a lot of people were just like, this is stupid.
Oh, right, and...
And a bunch of people, I believe from, like, Channel 101 and that sort of circle, decided it's like, okay, if anybody's gonna ruin RoboCop, it should be... So they remade, scene for scene, the movie RoboCop. Only each scene was given to a different... studio or independent artist whatever. And they didn't quite make them accurately. They took a little bit of artistic license in each of them.
So, well, also, they gave the RoboCop stops a rape scene to Fatal Farm.
Oh, that's exactly where I was going.
I knew it was, but I wanted to give context for Fatal Farm. They're the people that did Lasagna Cat.
Yes.
Oh my God.
It's...
Right.
You want like...
Is it like 30 minutes long?
It's like 10 solid minutes of him just shooting potential rapists in the dick. And it's
just
really graphic.
Just shooting dicks
off.
Like,
just exploding penises and balls and just, like, people falling over, like, vomiting.
It's
horrendous. It's so gory. Just over and over and over. And, like, they start swarming like ants and you're just like... It's incredible.
Yeah.
You can see it on YouTube, but consider yourself very warned.
Fit Farm does some shit.
They sure do.
Tor like McQueen. Tor thank. Bugman bad. No let Bugman eat Moomoos. I hope we can put a stop to these things attacking your Moomoos. Brahmin, I don't think anything would attack with both of us here.
So you're not actually done yet?
I guess not. There's probably, like, other bug... Oh, there are. There are other bugs.
Listen, listen, Scorpion.
You don't have a dick.
To the brain. Or just punch it, yeah.
I like the brain.
The brain's like the dick.
In that people often make decisions based on it.
Got there.
I like how it's easier to hit it in the brain than it is the head. That's environmental storytelling, kids. Inventory.
I think you can end combat to use it. Yeah, it doesn't automatically end combat. You're okay.
All right. You lost one hit poison level. Are there more bugmen?
I assume so. I think you just gotta wander
more
around.
Bumgen?
Alright, we murdered...
Maybe that was it. Maybe talk
we
to
brutally Thor. Murdered the cattle rustlers, though. So that's what's important.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
Did we save at any point? Well, we're about to.
Probably should. So we're coming up on our second break.
Tor like McQueen. Tor thank. Bugman bad. No let Bugman eat moo-moos. I hope we can put a stop to these things attacking your moo-moos. No, that... All right. There's still more to do. I guess we gotta find the third one? A third one?
Go get into trouble.
Oh, there's some.
Oh, there's
wow.
A bunch of
okay.
Them. Okay, here we go.
Bruh.
It's time for a fucking dust up.
Yeah.
Let's have a
we're gonna rumble.
Donnybrook!
Just tarps off, boys. Rip shirt off.
Is that what they said? Tarps off, boys? Let's have a Donnybrook?
Tarps.
Use a healing powder, maybe.
Was it Kathleen that can't watch that show because it's not funny at all?
Letterkenny?
Yeah.
Yeah, I showed her one of the original shorts and she's like, it's too real.
Like, it's too accurate to
be
funny?
Yeah.
Like, that's... I knew those guys. The pattern, it's really
it's
strong.
It's very
though.
Snappy.
Oh, it's very snappy.
Like, the quality of writing is just.
Yeah. Holy shit.
No, it's very, very good. But yeah, it's. When I told her Kevin Owens was Canadian, she's like, yeah, no kidding. He looks like drug dealers from Prince George.
Which one was Kevin Owens?
I'll show you a picture.
What's going on with your fucking body here? I guess that's what a Canadian accent sounds like, huh?
Yeah.
For the more extreme regional ones, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Dang.
Yeah.
Lead these things over to Tor, see if he'll help out. Will he?
Will he?
I can't remember.
Let's hold up all our action points and let it come to us. Ah!
It worked.
How are y'all? Good and you? Not so bad. Oh, come on, King. I won't tell anyone. Little 5-on-1.
Aw, oh, she's bashful.
I gotta pass out.
Like, I absolutely knew those guys.
Distributing some literature.
Wow, you one-shotted that one.
Yeah.
You killed all the rad scorpions.
Yay!
And the Brahmin.
Oh.
Now you can end combat. That's the one thing that's super unintuitive. Is being like, oh, I killed them. And then you try to do stuff, and it's like, you don't have the AP for it. And you're like, what? Everything's dead. Oh, I'm still in combat.
Mm. I totally went to basic with people that were like Riley and Jonesy.
Oy, oy,
really?
Oy.
I believe it.
Yeah.
What's up, brah? Never skip leg day, brah.
I love the slow reveal that the hockey players are the worst players on their team and are just goons.
Yeah.
That's good.
Were the ones that came down the laneway?
Yeah. Came up the laneway? Came down?
A couple of hockey boys
came
up the
laneway
the other day.
Yeah. Took your shirt off and put your sunglasses on. What kind of dick face pageantry is this?
Back-ass work, was it?
Or, I don't know, I'm just
quoting. Oh,
just
yeah.
Yeah. No, come up the proto stand the other day.
What does this do?
I don't know. I wouldn't.
Okay,
so
well,
that's
good.
It?
Yeah, I guess GJ.
You just leave.
Okay.
You can look in that house, too, I suppose.
I don't want to steal from...
From Tor.
From Tor.
Poor Tor. All right,
poor Tor.
Are you going to fight in those shades or play PokerStars.com?
You should be able to just click there.
You see exit grid.
You can't just click there
you're
and leave?
You're fucking two-ply, bud.
No.
Click near there? Is there a range on this?
Maybe there is.
Weird, okay.
It's just too far away. Okay, well, fair.
Oh, that's to push someone.
Oh.
To shove them so they don't block your doorways.
Okay. Okay, so we're back in Klamath.
Save.
Right. Save game.
Shall we?
Take a break?
Yeah.
Now that we've made it here?
20 past.
Yeah, sure. Let's take a quick break.
All right.
We'll be back shortly, everyone. 5 minutes. Go do some self-care. Hey,
Graham
we're
was,
back.
Graham was feared into whelps.
Yeah, Graham was feared into the whelps. He'll be back with us in a couple of minutes, but he said not to wait on him. So let's get back into it. All right, so we've come to our first settlement in Fallout 2. What do we see? We've helped protect Tor's Brahmin.
So I get the impression that, this seems kind of,
Do you like kids?
That's weird.
What the? Want to play house?
Oh, it's actually a kid. So similar to the ones that I have played, there's like a central thread, which is go get the Gek and save the village.
Mm-hmm.
And you can fucking ignore that if you want.
Mm.
But I imagine, and feel free to confirm or deny this, that like there's a series of like points you hit along the course of.
Traitor. Yeah, well, I mean, you encounter a traitor here who tells you where to go to find things, and mm-hmm. then, yeah.
And then it's just, like, lots of stuff you can do in the meantime.
So let's look at Klamath's bulletin board. There are several things here, some ads, job notices, and even a drawing. It looks as if some of these have been here for a while.
There's a timer in Fallout 1?
Yeah, if you don't find the chip within a certain amount of time, everyone dies.
That sucks.
A crude drawing of what looks like a Brahmin with a big X through it and the word Tor scrawled underneath. Something about booze. Got your attention, didn't I? Bum leg prevents business. Need help or fueling still. Speedy and reliable type needed. See Whiskey Bob over at Ma Buckner's place. About a bath? Feeling grubby? Nothing makes a feller feel better than a nice bath. Three fun-filled types to choose from, featuring the beautiful and talented Jenny, Lady of the Den. See Big Nose Sal at the bathhouse for more exciting details. Oh, it would be nice to take a bath. Someone wants to buy some lizard hides. Top dollar for top pelts. You have gecko pelts? I have money. Golden gecko pelts especially welcome. Alright.
Just various money-making opportunities.
See something about rats. Too many damn rats in Trapper Town. Come and get them all you can eat. Slim. Something about old stuff? Genuine antiques. They don't make them like they used to. In fact, they mostly don't make it at all. If you want the good old stuff, see Vic the Trader, east side of downtown.
That's
the man we need. Missing person. Has anyone seen Smiley the Trapper? Smiley's about 6 feet tall, clean and housebroken, mostly. Disappeared up north and I kind of miss him. Arden Buckner. All right.
So you can look at your map.
Map.
And now you have a map of the town.
Hey! What? There's a resolution setting?
Kinda.
That's kinda sweet.
Motion sensor not installed. What's your deal? Hello there, I haven't seen you in Klamath before. I'm Aldo, the town greeter. It's my job to greet anyone new in town to answer any questions they might have about our bucolic little burg. Welcome to Klamath. Who might you be?
You can tell he's drunk
McQueen.
Because he's hiccuping.
Thanks for welcoming me here.
Renegade option, just like grab him by the ears and headbutt him so hard his forehead caves in.
Headbutt him in the groin.
Just like drop to your knees and just crunch.
Well, friend McQueen, since you're new to these parts and look as though you could use some pointers, I'll let you know that it's customary to tip the town greeter before asking any questions.
Hey,
and
wait
such.
A second.
Yeah, bye. All right, east side of town, you say?
Oh, Marius is over there.
Hmm?
I'm making shitty jokes.
Oh, where do we even
try
go?
Going in there?
Yeah.
What?
Hello?
Oh, I remember Arden's... this building.
Yeah.
Hello there, my name's Arden Buckner, and this is my place. Say you didn't see a trapper named Smiley outside of town, did you? Half to herself. He's been gone for too long. She never should have let him go off on that fool quest of his. Well, Smiley and me were getting downright serious with each other. I thought I had finally gotten him to agree to settle down here and help me run this place, but he said he needed to go off on one last quest. Quest? Well, he called it a quest. He told me he thought he knew where all the golden geckos come from, and he wanted to find out for sure. He thought that maybe it was some kind of magical spring, or maybe a hidden cave or vault of some sort. Well, I don't rightly know what all he said, but he seemed real excited about going. But I shouldn't have let him go. He's 2 weeks later getting back than he said he'd be, and I'm worried. I need a room, please.
Do you, though?
Do I?
Nah.
Do you just get mugged if you stay here?
Maybe.
I don't think so, but...
No.
You know,
maybe this is a different building than I thought.
I was gonna say, how often in RPGs do you, like, immediately encounter the first inn,
mm-hmm.
and you're compelled, maybe through sheer politeness, to just stay the night, even if you don't have to?
Mm.
It's like the middle of the day. You're just like, I want a room. They're like, okay. And you sleep, and you maybe get your 2 hit points back that you lost, and you're like, why did I do that?
What's wrong with me?
All right, where's Maida?
Well, she said daughter. There's only... Oh, no, there's 2 women in the room.
Winks at you.
Got me a good trap line south of here. Stay away from the Duntons?
Best stay away from me.
Wait, what?
Be Sulik's twin. There
My name's Maida Buckner. I take care of trading and drinks here. What will it be for you, friend? Need to buy some things.
Give me stuff.
You want a barter? Always looking for quality gecko pelts, and I pay a fair price for them, too.
Flares! Medikit. All.
$60? Hell yeah.
Ching.
Our spear. We probably don't need a knife, do we?
I don't know.
Eh, let's keep it. Ooh. Flare, spear, first aid kit.
Stimpak.
Crowbar, throwing knife.
Throwing knife?
Booze.
It's really good.
Beer. Stimpak is good.
Well, Stimpak is like...
Hey, Nuka-Cola!
Stimpak is the healing item.
Right.
Right. Gecko pelt, meat jerky, healing powder. Leather armor.
Ooh.
How much do they want for that?
The leather armor?
Yeah.
Wow! Hella! Ooh.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Alright.
$380, huh?
Wow!
I think we'll be okay.
Well, sell that shit anyway.
You can at least get... Wait, no, you're offering...
Oh! For nothing. You have to take money.
Yeah.
Oh!
And I mean, they'll take the offer.
Mm-hmm.
If you hold shift, it goes up by 5s or 10s or something.
All right.
I thought this was the brothel.
Ah!
It's not.
What happens in the brothel, Graham?
You can join it. Like, as an employee.
A contractor?
I guess, yeah.
Check inventory. Find bed bugs.
Oh, no! Hell no!
I believe you can become a contractor, regardless. Is that it there? Bathhouse, yes.
Bathhouse, yes. I assume.
My phone.
Vix. There we go.
You can become an employee regardless of gender, but I believe you have to have reasonable charisma.
I like that this kid is just running after you like.
Like kids do.
Like kids do. They're like, hey, I have like a million questions because my dad told me to fuck off.
Children will steal from you sometimes.
I mean,
you can search that desk too, I think.
A kid that steals from you sounds like they're asking for a bribe.
Hello!
Hello!
He's got fucking 4 of these canteens?
Get it.
collectible card game. Looks like it'd be an expensive
tragic
hobby if you get hooked.
Cards!
Deck of tragic
Whoa.
Cards. Water flask.
I feel
beer.
Personally attacked.
No. Yoink.
What year did this come out?
98.
I don't want to steal from Vic. We don't need to steal from Vic. Where is Vic, anyway?
You don't need to steal from Vic.
But you can steal from Vic.
And there's that bookcase, too. That crumbled-ass bookcase. You don't need to steal from Vic, but you probably should.
Dude, they might have Stronghold and Exodus cards. Yeah, the first 98 set was Stronghold.
Tragic
the accumulation.
Now you have a gun.
Where is Vic? Where'd he go?
He's out right now.
I guess so.
Maybe he's in the shitter.
Maybe.
Shitter's full.
Should have locked his, No, shitter's empty.
Can you search the crapper?
Oh my god.
Yes.
A crude but effective toilet. There's some leaves dropped into the hole to manage the odor.
Poorly.
Manage the odor.
They are ineffective.
I don't think this is a spoiler, but can I tell them about the outhouse that was very remote? That we encountered?
Just that there was a remote outhouse? I mean...
Well, I knew that it was remote. Because there was one poo in it.
Right, yes. That is pretty funny.
That was pretty funny.
I bet you to do bathe.
What?
Yeah, I think there's a... Yeah, someone said there's a magazine in one of these houses, which I think is correct.
I wasn't able to see one there.
No. Well, I'll keep looking around town, I guess.
Yeah. What's in the bathhouse?
Do you have some food? Faga! Hello!
Sup there, girl.
My name's Sally Dunton, but mostly call me Big Nose Sally. I'm the owner of this here bathhouse. We have a whole hassleful of special attended baths for you to pick from.
Hassleful?
What kind of special attended baths you got here?
Special baths that we have available varying costs by the amount of time the gal spends with you and any special services that you take advantage of. Bye. Sorry that we couldn't help you out. Come back later, though. Done.
I won't. Didn't we kill her brothers? Kid just runs inside.
Jerky.
Look at all this shit that wasn't locked up.
There's another room in that building.
The Golden Gecko.
So, is that what straight bathhouses are? Because that's not what gay bathhouses are. Is that where the expression to get steamy comes from?
Probably not.
I have no idea. Definitely dick punched one of her relatives to death. Two of them.
Yeah.
I mean, nothing.
Those guys, dickless now.
And dead.
It's like you can still have an open casket, but. Try blades, razors.
No rest for the poor.
Uh huh. What's in this building?
Open casket, closed fly. What kind of funeral? No, don't answer that question. It's just like an open casket.
An open fly funeral? How good of a porn star do you have to be
to
qualify for an open fly funeral?
Like, we can just say Ron Jeremy.
I guess.
Are they going to do like a ring toss?
I mean, if they can, it's only to the testament of the Undertaker at that point. Can be locked. Didn't say it was locked.
Let's not steal from directly in front of them. Child.
They were in the other room. Shove that child.
Have they stolen from me yet? No, they haven't. This is basically just a zip gun, right? Handmade single-shot rifle, minimum strength 5. It has one-on-one shots of 10mm JHP.
And is that what that round is?
Well,
yep.
10mm JHP, jacketed hollow points.
Neat.
Where the hell is Trader Vic?
There's elsewhere in town. There's the Golden Gecko.
Yeah, let's look at Golden Gecko first.
Harumph.
Spits on floor. What do you want? I guess this is the flop house and
you
bar.
You can just click. You don't have to
burn. Oh, okay. Sorry.
No, I'm just letting you know.
Points for what? Oh, the sweet science, of course. The sporting art. What are you talking about? Pugilism. Manly art of hand-to-hand combat. That's what I mean.
I love that one of your options there is, I already know more about that than you can teach me.
Hmm.
I'm curious if this will actually gain you anything.
Several sweaty hours later. So you see what you're doing wrong then? Yeah.
Oh. John Sullivan has helped you improve your melee and unarmed combat skills.
Nice.
Hey!
Let me give you $10 for some brew on me. That's the least I can do. No, no, no. I could nay take the money from you. It was my very own pleasure to teach you what I know. You take darn good care of yourself now. You got real potential.
Huh. How about that?
Where'd you learn to fight like that? Ah, that was a long time ago, when I was a wee young lad and didn't have any sense in me thickhead. A place called Reno. You keep your nose clean and stay away from the likes of that place. Where's that? Ah, didn't want to tell you. You get on now. Just keep out of harm's way. Goodbye now.
Executive Hall, if you missed the beginning of the stream, we started with Fallout 2 because in the same style as many sequels, it's kind of the quintessential of the 2D games. I mean, there was only the three of them, right?
Yeah, and one was a different genre.
Yeah. I guess the comparison we could draw is like System Shock versus System Shock 2. Like, System Shock 2 is the one that gets all the attention and press because it was a very, very good game. Or at least a very iconic one.
You get such a trade.
Yeah.
And my understanding is it's the same like that with this, so.
Our sharpened spear, which we will never use.
Our sharpened kniff, which we shall never use.
There's the,
the zip gun.
There's those 6 cans of beer. Bottles of beer.
Yeah.
One of these games, they have to have, like, pipe and other pipe, and then you combine them and you just get a slam fire shotgun.
Maybe you can't afford it just yet. Close, though. You can just go to talk to get out of.
Ah, yes. Nope. Oh my god. We've broken it.
Oh, right. You can sell your other spike knuckles.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, and that gun.
Yeah.
We...
Hey!
Oh, yeah. There we go.
What does Street Fighter 1 actually look like?
I couldn't tell you.
I don't actually know.
Oh!
What? What is that?
You can get some more stuff off him.
Brah.
Yeah. How much for the armor?
It's so expensive.
It is so expensive. But, I mean, what do we have here?
Not much.
I mean, this looks similar. It looks pretty bad.
Yeah, not a lot here.
Yeah, the booze isn't enough.
Oh, well.
What else has he got? How much are... actually, that would be still better than what you have.
It would.
Is this a leather coat, I think?
Yeah.
Although, how many rounds of 10 mil do you have?
24.
Maybe just ammo. Shrez 2? I don't know.
Ooh, the ammo's expensive.
Easily readable body copy? Yeah, ammo, I mean, you don't need all 72.
Just buy a spam can. Can you just type it in?
Yes, you can.
Oh.
Hey! Wait.
You're supposed to be able to.
Maybe just.
Oh, they come in packs of 24. It's that's three packs.
So we need like 300?
You could offer it.
I mean, do we need the money to trade with Vic?
So,
I don't know.
Tell me more about this offer mechanic. So you can actually just like haggle with people?
Kinda.
That's kind of neat, because in
not good
most
enough.
Of the other Fallout games, and like games of this ilk, the prices are very firm. Or you're like, I will use the bartering skill.
So, like, it's different. Like, you can't, in here, you can't just... No, there's three stacks total.
Oh. So, one stack.
Yeah. You can't, so now you should get some cash from him. So
yeah.
This is sort of set at this stage. Like you can offer it, but if it's bad for them in any way, they won't take it. If it's good, then they will. That sort of gets worked out ahead of time.
Hmm.
Based on, yeah, so like there's your existing bartering skill, there's your charisma. There's lots of things that affect the prices, but once you get into that screen, it's basically just...
Hmm.
The way it is.
Interesting.
Cool. Now you have gun it.
Yeah.
I do like
a
the
Colt
idea.
6520 10mm auto-loading pistol. Each pull of the trigger will automatically reload the firearm until the magazine is empty.
That's the gun you were talking about.
Yep. That's the big old...
It's loaded.
Yep.
All right. Ah, 12 shots. All right.
All right, Vic.
Where are
you
at?
You. There's another outhouse up there, directly above the gecko.
Oh, there it is. Yes.
Oh, 10mm. Because fuck 9mm. For some reason, I don't know. Can we shoot people in the dick? Yeah, I guess.
What's that? Oh, Cat's Paw Magazine.
What?
An issue of Cat's Paw Magazine. It weighs 1 pound.
So, see if you can use it. No.
Nope.
Oh.
Well, you can sell it. So now we can shoot people in the groin? Hell yeah.
Blast them.
Cannot go this way. Cannot
no,
go this
you can
way.
Go west.
I can.
What the fuck is that? Oh god. That seems bad. Wait, is it fighting you?
Oh yeah.
Yep.
It began a combat.
Okay. That seems out of your league.
Well. If you go down, there's another way to go.
Oh, there is too.
That zone.
How realistic is 10mm for stopping radioactive scorpions? I don't know. Do you mean like actual 10mm caliber? Because it's not what I imagine this game thinks it is.
I imagine a bullet can hurt something quite badly, even if it is a large animal.
Who are those people?
Sometimes I think I've seen a really big rat back in the buildings there.
A backwoodsman.
Mm.
Oh, you're in Trapper Town.
Yeah, like 10mm is substantially larger than 9mm.
Trade hides for firewater? Uh-huh.
I believe you can search the post box? No.
I like the cars.
Yeah. The cars that run on nukes.
Mm.
Well, ran on nukes. What's in there?
like, just the mise-en-scène of these places is really telling. Oh, like, just the misery of it.
Oh,
a lot of crap.
That's, yeah. That's fallout.
You're from the Arroyo tribe, ain't you? Can tell by your looks.
What are you saying?
It's cheap to live here, but you have to put up with the rats.
Yeah, one... Oh, yeah, you can go... I think there's a place to go down to sewers in here.
Oh, yeah, you can go ratting?
Clean out some rats.
Rats!
No, we didn't end up trading for the armor. It's all too expensive. one of the people said you look like a ringer for Sulik.
Oh, yeah, Sulik.
Yeah, Sulik is a tribal guy who can... he can be... a companion.
That's a hell of a sachet.
Yep.
Yep. I became friends with Sulik and then very quickly became not friends with Sulik after I discovered that this game, if I'm the player character, and Alex, you're Sulik, and there's an enemy between us, and I shoot at the enemy and miss, it could hit you.
Oh no, you shot Sulik in the back.
No, in the front. We were both fighting this guy.
Oh,
oh no.
Just ate it. Huh.
But Sulik got very upset with me.
Huh!
Oh no.
Yeah, so, to note, friendly fire is on.
A thing.
And
okay.
You can accidentally shoot your companions.
That's not so good.
Healing powder. See what that powder is. Just take them all. Right, Sulik is good with fist, spear, big hammer, and submachine gun. That's our Sulik.
She's gone. Through the corm.
Well, let's go see if Vic is back yet.
Vic! Vic! Hey, Vic!
Do you know Vic?
Lots of Brahmin going missing.
Yeah, I don't think that's going to be a problem anymore.
Sewers have a free gun and a car part that makes the car use half fuel. Oh, right, you do eventually get a car.
Right, yeah. The
Is it fast travel?
Yep.
Kinda.
Well, yeah, I'm faster travel.
I can't remember what it's actually called. It's faster travel with fewer encounters, I think.
Oh, that's... Or, like...
How do you get to the sewers?
Go down the manhole cover, I think.
I mean, yeah, but that...
But where? Where is that?
Or do you have to talk with somebody?
Up back there? There's more to do back... Oh, guns!
Oh, hey!
There's a store that says guns!
That seems handy. Can we maneuver through this place?
Yep.
I thought this was blocked off for some reason. It is. Alley inaccessible.
Oh, there's a door there.
Wait, yep.
Up, no, in the side of that building. On your right.
Oh. Hello there, friend. Nice of you to visit us here. My name's Slim Pickett. I talk for Trapper Town.
Call this Trapper Town.
Well, this here part of town is where all of us trappers live when we're not out trapping geckos. Only problem about the free digs is the rats are on the north side, but we have most of the entrances to that part of the town mall barricade pretty good. Rats? What about rats? Well, they taste pretty good if you spit roast them with just a titch of herbs, but most of the time they can be a real nuisance, and they're getting worse. We've barricaded in the north side of town, but they're sneaking through anyway.
I like how you bond over fried rats.
Yeah, people have been disappearing just as them are slow and sickly now. Of course, they don't stop. Okay, I need you to slow down, son. Of course, they don't stop to cook their food like us. They just gnaw down to a few bloody clumps of hair and rags. At least that's all we can find in the morning. I've even heard talk there's some kind of giant rat god that tells them what to do.
That's really gross.
Huh. You want the key to the north side of Trapper Town? What do you want that for? I'm an explorer. Besides...
I want to help you with your rat problem?
Yeah. Oh, that sounds like...
Well, okay, here's the key. Just don't go stirring up too much trouble back there and make sure you close the door behind you. Thanks, Slim.
Hey! Fight the rats.
But don't fuck the rats.
But fight the rats.
Okay. Slim Pickens? Why do I know that name?
He was an actor.
Slim Pickens was in Dr. Strangelove.
Yeah, he was the...
Right. Yeah.
He was the guy who rode the bomb.
Yeah.
This guy's name is
nice.
Slim Pickett, but an obvious...
Illusion. Obvious reference.
Yeah.
Don't king shame. Rats can't consent. Guns! Also in that, like, cowboy font.
Mm-hmm.
So you know they're good quality American guns.
Well, let's check out the gun shop.
I wonder how many rounds are going to be fired into the air tomorrow. And then how many of those are going to beam somebody in the head.
Ah.
Oof. Ow.
Hopefully not too many.
Yeah, not too many.
How do you get... Oh, the gun store is... There's the door is actually... You can't see the door right now because it's in the area that you were occupying. There it is.
Ah, yes, there.
Yeah, y'all be safe on National Explosion Day tomorrow.
Looks like the gun store is cleaned out.
Yeah, that's a thing you can check too.
Make sure your plate carriers or floor tiles wrapped in duct tape are secured properly.
Aha! Sick.
Poor doggos.
Boots.
And cats?
Rubber boots.
I believe they're called wellies.
Game calls galoshes. Them rubber boots. Galoshes.
What's the difference between a wellie and a galosh?
They're the same.
Yeah, they're... Yeah.
Where you live.
Yeah, better answer. Mm. Yes. So, yeah, you can spend a lot of time
There's
in this game just dirtling around.
Oh, yeah.
As is the case in much of, well, like, open-ended RPGs like this, you know, part of the appeal is just how much you can just sort of take it at your own pace and do whatever the hell you feel like.
Let them come.
I guess it's not worth wasting bullets on.
Yeah, there's no way we use bullets on them.
We just keep killing them, really. Basically PUBG? Yeah. It was one person and
no survival.
99 rats, yeah.
Yeah. The lab has its own fireworks. Yeah, after a fashion. Cam, what's the worst thing that could catch fire in a lab?
And you. Not entirely facetious.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, anything that catches fire in the lab is really just a mechanism for catching you on fire.
Yeah.
It's just a medium for transmitting flame from, well, to you.
Something in the sodium column on the table?
Yeah. Yeah. Metal fires are very, very bad.
Yeah. You have to dose those with, like, sand.
Yeah, anything that's not in a fume hood is very, very bad.
Mm. Compressed gases.
Plutonium burns. Metal fires are the worst.
Plutonium burns. That's so horrible because that stuff's really fucking poisonous to start with.
Like, many metals will burn. All metals will burn, I think.
It's like, oh, we got us a, that's a plutonium fire. That's bad.
I mean, the British found out the very hard way in the Falklands War that aluminum will burn because they had been building their ships out of aluminum.
Uh-huh.
And, the Royal Navy found out that you can't fight that fire with water.
Yeah, that's,
Oh, good.
Yeah.
I think they lost...
It's just like, oh, I thought we were avoiding the magnesium problem.
Did you... I can't remember why I was looking it up, but did you see the radio the radio transmission at the beginning of the Falklands War?
No.
Between London and the Falklands?
No.
Oh no, this is gonna be bad.
No, it's actually kind of amazing.
zeros were made out of magnesium, weren't they?
It was on the Wikipedia page.
I think some number of World War II airframes were made out of magnesium.
I mean, many aircraft were made out of aluminum because it's light and you know, strong.
It was a telex conversation?
Yes, the telex.
You lit a jet of aerosolized aluminum on fire? I mean...
What the shit? I think I've told this story a couple times about when I poured water on a liquid fire and found out why you don't ever pour water on a liquid fire. My brother and I had been melting candles and like in a tin can, and the tin can caught fire, and I panicked and Raymond didn't. And I just like yelled over top of him to go get some water, and he was trying to stammer out, "No, you shouldn't do that." And so he brought me water, and I poured water on it, and it shot like a 6-foot column of flame out the top.
Right, so this is a communication between London and the base in the Falklands.
Okay.
London. Hello there, what are all these rumors we hear? This is London. Falklands. We have lots of new friends. London. What about invasion rumors? Those are the friends I was meaning. They have landed. Absolutely. Are you open for traffic, i.e. normal telex service? No. Orders on that yet. One must obey orders. Whose orders? The new governors. Argentina. Yes. Are the Argentinians in control? Yes, you can't argue with thousands of troops plus enormous navy support when you are only 1,600 strong. Stand by.
It's like, wow. I'm sorry, were you just invaded? That is, yes, more or less what I've been trying to say.
We and got then, a little bit invaded.
And then the line went dead because the Argentinians cut it.
Jeez. You know Raymond Briggs did a comic about the Falklands?
Sorry, I just love the opening is, what are all these rumors we hear?
Yeah.
We have lots of new friends. No, the invasion rumors. Yeah. Those are the friends I was talking about.
I was trying to be surreptitious.
Oh, yeah. Gee, shit posting. Yeah, he did. It was called The Tin Pot General and the Iron Lady. It's nice. Pretty wild.
So many bullets.
Bullets!
Time to use this gun, I think.
Bullets and
guns. I think it's more time to use healing powder.
Oh, yeah,
powder.
You're at 19, sure. Alright, let's do it.
I mean, I'm one punching these things anyways. They aren't really hurting me that badly. We'll just engage in fisticuffsmanship with the rats.
How many sheep were lost during that conflict?
I don't know. Potentially none.
Poor rats. This is like in Deep Space Nine, when they go into the past and wind up in trouble with Tribbles. How O'Brien gives Worf shit about the tremendous amount of damage that the Tribbles caused to the Klingon Empire. When Kirk stashed all the Tribbles on that one Klingon cruiser. And he's like, yes, the Tribbles devoured our food supplies for 3 colonies. Millions died in the famines that followed. It wasn't resolved until we hunted the Tribbles down to their homeworld and destroyed it.
Yeah.
And O'Brien's like, lol. Are songs still sung of the great Tribble hunt?
3 civilians killed by British shelling.
Doesn't mention sheep.
Oh, they're running away. They're afraid!
That's why we use the ranged weapon.
Beavers for tax purposes? In that case, 27 casualties.
This reminds me of the sound effects in that one Monty Python sketch where the guy has trained mice to squeak out the tones of 3 blind mice.
Wow!
And it's just hitting them with mallets while he goes, and the audience is like, no, stop him.
He's horrified. He gets run off the...
Oh, man.
Oh yeah, I guess you should save.
Yep. Oh right. But we're an invincible murder machine. Nothing may stand before us.
Not even a rat god? Rat god?
Wait, Flying Circus is on Netflix?
Yeah.
Yo! Is it on Canadian Netflix?
Yes, Julie's been watching it.
It's so good.
I should watch it again.
There's so much great stuff that gets forgotten because it's not in the movies.
Yeah,
there's really, really good
stuff.
I
know exactly what I'm doing when I get home.
I love their exit strategy for sketches sometimes. Just like when I remember where, like, they were like, no, it's too silly. They didn't know how to end the sketch. So they just cut to the apartment below the one they were doing the sketch in with the guy pounding on the ceiling with a broom.
Wow!
That was a really good one, yeah.
Yep.
Oh yeah, we got that level.
Next level.
Ooh, pick a perk.
Pick a perk. These are different perks, by the way.
Oh.
Ew.
Kama Sutra Master.
What?
Wow. When it comes to Jesus.
Whoa, wait, what?
Where are her... What are those limbs?
You have a third leg!
That's yes. Not a leg. Presence. You command attention just by walking into a room. The initial reaction of another person is improved by 10% for each of them. Perk. Quick pockets. I like that. Just... you rip it out of your pocket so fast that coins get shot through the drywall in three neighboring rooms.
your CC draw is so fast you just kill the guy with your holster. He's just got Kydex stuck in his chest. And he's like,
or there's just like the bolt of wind from you quick drawing snuffs out can't. Like there's just a crater in the dude's chest and candles on the
like
opposite side of the room.
Like a flap of face skin comes out. Holy shit.
You put her on all the candles in the room blow out.
Oh, man.
Night vision. With a night vision perk, you can see better in the dark. Oh. Here and now. With this perk, you immediately gain one experience level. Neat. Earlier sequence, comprehension. When reading, you gain 50% more skill points when reading books. You're more alert. Okay. Hmm.
I think there's more if you scroll down, I could be wrong.
Oh, there are too. Swift Learner.
Mm.
Ooh, if we take Swift Learner early, that would be really
good.
Oh,
yeah, Swift Learner just gives you 5% XP, right?
Yeah.
Whenever you earn XP.
Yeah, let's take that.
Windmill Slam.
Just, yeah, wow, okay.
Gunnets.
Turn your speech up, and you can get more interesting options.
Ooh, yeah, good point.
Now, let's go talk to this rat.
Just clicking on rats down here.
Now, where's the big rat?
I don't know.
It's around.
The Rat King.
Do you remember, there was somebody who wrote like a short little post about where all the milk went?
No, I don't know.
It was pretty revolting.
Do
you know about this?
No. What do you mean the milk?
This isn't gonna make any sense and I'm probably gonna butcher it. There's apparently some sort of, I think like school, food program that Margaret Thatcher canceled.
Okay.
And somebody wrote like a really weird, gross thing about like her dead body like swelling up and rupturing and being full of rotten milk.
Weird.
Because she had taken all the milk?
She had hoarded it.
Nice.
Yeah, it was weird. These are new glasses.
A very large pile of bleached bones. You cannot determine the species of the dead critters.
I hope somebody else has heard of this and I'm not just like imagining things.
There's another level down.
There's also just more of this level.
There is. So much of it, in fact. Well, not so much of it.
You can just head for the ladder.
Hmm. Hmm.
Stop! Stop!
Doob a doob a doob doob, punching rodents. We'll probably get to subs shortly as well.
All right.
The old classic dungeon crawl.
Yeah. Wow. So much XP. Oh no! We wandered into the rat.
I also enjoy that the combat. Engaging sound is the same in this game as it is in Fallout 3 and 4.
Hmm. This empty metal barrel has the nuclear trefoil plant symbol painted on the side in bright yellow paint. Alarming. Let's not disturb that, shall we? No. I just wanted to make sure we weren't missing anything up here. I didn't...
Rats, apparently.
Yeah, rats.
Spacebar! I knew there was a shortcut for it. Spacebar ends your turn.
Oh, cool.
Oh.
A man is walking around in the dungeon, and what does he find? Rats! Rats! Rats!
Now is the time on Sprocket's end, he dies.
Okay. Looks like we've murdered all the rats here, as suits our great heroism.
Oh, except that one.
Hans, you're beautiful and angular, and if you're a gas, you'd be in it.
Wow. May I say?
Graham looks more lurkery than usual. That's because he's behind us. He's in our blind spot. That's a bad idea. I almost reflexively just did a no-look elbow.
Just, oh! There's a big boy.
Is that a big, healthy boy?
Hello? Tough pig rat.
Pig rat?
That's a hell of a thing to say to me. Like I just know what that is. Turns out we're fighting a frat king.
Whoa, what the- Whoa, hello?
I love the term frat king.
Is it like when all the bros get their puka shell necklaces stuck together?
Yeah.
Nice.
Puka the, shell.
Yeah, yeah, the you know, the shell necklaces.
I don't
from the
actually.
Early 2000s.
PUCA.
Ew. Wow, I can smell those guys. You know, just like the column of axe.
What the?
It can talk.
It can talk.
Talk to it.
It's already talking. You missed. The bruise will look nice, and maybe the scars will make good party talk. Critically hit for 2 points.
Dang.
Considering you were then normally hit
hungry,
for...
What the fuck?
Considering you were then normally hit for 5.
Ooh. Huh.
It's a bad crit.
Yeah. I mean, lucky for you. I believe you need to reload. Oh, no, you're okay.
Leroad?
Right, come.
You're almost
come to
dead.
King.
You're super almost dead. I think you need to heal.
Correct.
I just want to look at it. Severely wounded.
You see an albino mole rat with an enlarged brain case. He's frothing at the mouth.
Gross. Okay. Stimpak? Do you have a Stimpak?
Do I have a Stimpak? I do.
Ooh.
he has a name.
Hey!
Oh wait, it's not dead yet.
Yep. Don't stop.
Unload on it. You know what you have to do.
You hit it in the groin. I mean, you can also shoot it in the groin if you really want. You killed it. You killed
with a groin shot.
You have killed King Rat.
All right, we should definitely save.
Okay.
On a different slot. All right. So we're continuing with this next week?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, I mentioned that the tentative plan was Fallout Summer.
Yes.
With Fallout 2 in July and then Fallout 4 in August?
Yeah.
Or 3?
Yeah.
4.
I'm okay.
Yeah. I'm really excited about this, actually, because I've only played a little bit of this game. Like I said, probably only about 20 hours or so. And you can see how much content you can get into in 20 hours of this game.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Small amount. So we're going to be playing this for the rest of the month, and then in next month we'll come back with one of the contemporary Fallout games. And we're really looking forward to sharing that all with you. So come back next week if you want to see more of this. But we should thank our subs and contributors.
It's just not Dave for 19 months.
Miss Kale with a new sub. Welcome.
Discordian Token gave us 300 bits saying, hooray, Alex, Cam, and Graham.
The Dead Virgin for 17 months. Hey, Cam, nice mug. Welcome back, Alex. How was your break? Also, bonus Graham, nice. It was good.
You're very quiet when you do these.
I am?
Yeah.
Oh.
Dark Lord Stratos with a 9-month resub. Sub Baby came along just in time for the return of Alex.
Get Yoryu gave us 150 bits. Welcome back, Alex. Glad to have you. Colon 3. A tiny bit sad that you missed out on Monster Hunter World, though. It's a good game if you haven't played it.
Rose Bitter with 100 bits. Flag 100.
Vios with 11 months. Welcome back, Alex.
The Magic Walrus came back for the 19th month. Thank you very much.
Ziff underscore for 28 months. 28 months, that's a number divisible by 2.
DRS Corbin, 100 bits. Hooray, bits for Alex's return as a congrats to all the guests hosts over his vacation.
Pun Spectre, resub for the 11th month. Appropriate number considering I'm subscribing with Prime. Ooh.
Dear Griffin 3, sub for 58 months in a row. Ooh, we're playing a Fallout game that I know next to nothing about. Excitement.
Quest here, 7-month resub. Welcome back, Alex. Hope you enjoyed your time off.
Kiariel, resub for the 22nd month. Talking Sim Triple Threat Night. Woo!
Woo!
Drain 10 for 12 months. It's been a year. Time flies when you're enjoying excellent content.
Brain Bosch, 16-month resub. I never managed to finish Fallout 2 due to a game-breaking bug 40 hours in. Hope you do better.
You've stepped on my line for the last time. Tim B has just subscribed. Welcome to the channel. Thank you for deciding to support us.
Rocketman, 210, sub for 10 months. Oh boy, the classic RPG that made everyone realize isometric RPGs didn't have to be D&D clones, and yet they did.
The fanatic asp. For the 4-month resub. Still love you guys. You make me feel better when I'm going through hard times.
Eli806 resub for the 54th month. Vague whispering about a metal husband.
Secret lover. Arclade, sub for 49 months. Welcome back, Alex.
Will Plaid, 27th resub. It's your boy Will Plaid coming at you with some hot radiation.
DJ Shire resub for the 38th month. Good to see you back, Alex, and Fallout games are rad.
GTS for 23 months. Welcome back.
Type 1, 100 bits. Alex, back?
Discordian Token gave us 100 bits saying, bloody mess.
Sorry, Pam. Phyrexian Pun Lord cheered with 100 bits. Bloody mess gives your character an alternate ending in Fallout 1. Not sure if it does anything in 2.
I don't think it does. Drekass with 13-month resub. Time to resub, I see. Have fun.
Minor Junior resub for the 5th month. Thank you.
Edmund Juniper for 17 months. Hello, friends from the internet.
The Magic Sausage with 29-month resub. You guys sure know how to click the thing. Click with all your might!
Gawkly resub for the 19th month. Remember to save frequently, because no autosaves will get you.
It'll get you.
and in
13 Punlord.
Ah, Phyrexian Punlord traded with 200 bits. And Fallout 1, you took Bloody Mess trait when the Overseer goes to lock you out of the vault at the end of the campaign. You blow off half his body instead of walking into the wasteland peacefully. Fallout Tactics, it has no effect. The reason being, the effect was one to show the horrors of combat. Wasteland changed your character.
Lord Orcus with a 32-month resub. Welcome back, Alex, for my favorite stream and streamers.
Tweaker69 is just nice.
Lady Amethea, 13, sub for 4 months. I think because of my prime hiccup in ownership, I'm eternally stuck at 4 months. Should be 13 now. Have a fun Fallout.
Oh, weird, but thank you. 100 bits from Alex White Chats. Fallout New Vegas was the first and only entry in the series I got my hands on, so this was really fascinating. Welcome back, Alex. I'm glad you had a good rest. I'm so happy to see you.
Haziosora gave 500 bits. Yay, Alex is back. Let the cat base randomness begin. Quack.
Wait. Dr. Game is a new sub. Welcome to the channel.
The one called Stu, 39 months, haven't subbed on Talking Sim as far as I'm aware.
Oh, thank you. Obi-Wan Canadian resub for the 29th month. Yay, the triumphant return of Alex.
Gorgon's Mind, sub for 25 months. All skill points to punching KO, Deathclaw called shots to the head.
Digi Goner, brand new sub. Welcome.
Pope Deadpool is a brand new sub as well. Welcome to the channel.
As is Boss Stallion, thanks.
Lonely Text, 27-month resub. 27 months? That's like 3 sub babies, right?
Goblin Ranger is resub for the 15th month. Oh, hey, notify button. Always good to get back from work to some good old lure. Thanks for all you do.
Thank you. Slightly Insane for 6 months. Well, resub message finally worked. Thanks for all the streams. Hope to be resubbing for a while.
A.W. McMillan, a brand new sub. Apologies for the yawn. Welcome to the channel.
Haven 7 gave us 150 bits, saying, hey all, for those who might not know, I used to go by the username Itazu. Ah. Hello.
Hi. Mastix is a new sub. Welcome.
Vertec289 resub for... Oh my god, I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Sorry, Graham.
Vertec289 with an 18-month resub. They call him the Groin Puncher.
Cranston Snored resub for the 9th month. Unsubscribe Groin Facts. Thank you for subscribing to Groin Facts.
Original Garwolf sub for 18 months. This sub brought to you by Unobtainium Inc. And no, you can't have some.
Jay Pattermore, 21 months. Welcome back.
Stormy Sky resub for the 6th month. Glad to catch Talking Sim live. Hope you had a great holiday, Alex.
Jalasar for 24 months. It took 2 years, but finally it's time to punch rad scorpions in the brain.
Daticus Rex, 29 months. Welcome back.
Zed Alpha came back for the 29th month. So last month I celebrated my 27th birthday and I realized I've been watching y'all for well over half my bloody life. Also, on the scale of Fallout at one end and The Road on the other, how gonzo do you like your post-apocalypse? I love...
Depends on the day.
I think The Road is a good book. I almost said I love The Road. And I don't know that I like The Road, but it's very good.
Yeah. The Exploded Gamer for 5 months. Just checking in, watch the VOD later, have a nice night, y'all.
Zwells 3 has just subbed. Thank you for deciding to support us.
I'll sneak in then with Chris Cola. It was a 4 month resub. Thank you so much. It's okay. Alex.
Wait, what? Oh, God. Zwells 3 with 100 bits. Cheers from Kingston, Ontario.
Admiral Matt, 25 months. Welcome back, Alex.
Fletcherizer resub for the 2nd month. 2 months, hopefully, start of long things.
Long, long things.
Quiet, Jay. For 7 months.
Corin Horn, 4 month resub. When is LRR going to allow sponsorship on YouTube? I don't know if we as a Canadian channel are allowed to do that yet, or when we are, if we will, or what. Stay tuned for more.
Pseudonym Ken resub for the 26th month. Excited for a summer of Fallout. Welcome back, Alex.
Diamond MX for 7 months. Kajit has sub if you have coin. Wait, wrong game.
The Bear Bee, 7 month resub. I've been stuck in that vault for 7 months. What have I missed? Wizards printed what? Put me back in the vault.
Ah, oh god, what did I do?
You're fine, you're good. You're on Zed Alpha.
Okay. Wait, who's...
Cam's on Zed Alpha.
Oh, yes, sorry. Zed Alpha gave us 100 bits, saying, also, I'm super glad you got a chance to take a break, Alex, and thanks for coming back. Also, love the glasses. Quite fetching.
Ogier 300 for 34 months. Vault 34 is one of the Vault 10 vaults located in the Mojave Wasteland.
Coleopteryx, 7 month resub. Whoop, can't think of a word.
Gekyoryu gave 150 bits, so what do we get G for the full Fallout summer? Do we get G for the full summer?
I don't think that's feasible. I can't guarantee it. I just love Fallout, and I really wanted to be here for this one.
He has trialed.
Yeah, that's the main thing.
Of course, Graham is 100% welcome to be on any one of these that he wants to.
And I would love to, but I don't think I can't guarantee that. Yes, I am with a child. That's not how that means. Wait, whose turn is it? Revelio with a 17-month resub. I just heard a summer of Fallout, enough to make me sub. Well, I've been sub for 17 months. Must be rad sickness. Welcome back, Alex.
Fervius has cheered with 200 bits, saying next game is Zork, right?
Zizfish for 5 months. Welcome back.
Andrea Santh with 111 bits for the palindrome. Oh, do we have a palindrome? 4224.
Lovely. Nice. Cool. All right. Well, we will be back. Alex and I, at least, will be back next week with more Fallout 2, now that we have killed the rat god. And tomorrow, what's on the docket for tomorrow?
Filth?
Tomorrow, in the AM, 9 o'clock.
Yes.
And then, in the midday, watch and play.
Some shit, including there's some sort of human coming?
Potentially.
Potentially.
Mm. Special guest star.
There might be somebody.
Secret guest star.
Legends
unconfirmed.
Speak.
Legends whisper. Then tomorrow PM, AFK, Red November, as I believe was being played.
I'm looking forward to this. I will be on it, I believe.
Yeah, I think
Ben will be running it, and other people as well that are on the schedule, and I have not committed to memory. But we do have a docket for it.
Yeah. So. Join for all of that.
All right. Well, until then, see you all later.
Huzzah!